Good morning, New Mexico. Welcome to the Virtual Career Connection event brought to you by New Mexico Workforce Connection. Hope you're having a great day. We've got a great list of employers today, and we're going to be starting off today with Century Sign Builders. Roxana Myers, president, and Ryan Patterson, intern designer.
You know what? That's a wrong video.
And I can't get a certificate because I don't have signs.
Hey, so you're going to need all your ADA and...
Hi, guys. That's the wrong video. Eric, if you need to, I can do the video. I'm not sure how you got that one, but let me get to the right video. Okay, technology. It's downloading as we speak. So Earl, you weren't able to get it from that link? That's an odd. I am just finishing up with the download. And I will share
my... Hi, my name's Roxana Myers, and I own Century Sign Builders. We're so glad you've joined us today to talk about Century Sign Builders. Hi, my name's Roxana Myers, and I own Century Sign Builders. We're so glad you've joined us today to talk about Century Sign Builders and the opportunities we have and why you might want to join us. A little bit about us: we create environments that create great experiences. This is our why, what gets us up in the morning, and what we're passionate about. We create environments that create great experiences in two ways. One, with effective exterior and interior signage that helps a person navigate a building or a campus. So if you've ever been lost in a hospital or a college campus, well, we design, fabricate, and install the signage that helps you find your way. The second way in which we create environments that create great experiences is by designing, fabricating, and installing spaces that inspire. I have a video to show you examples of how we've transformed spaces that inspire. As we're all preparing to get back to work, school, and go out to restaurants, we want to be sure that we have the spaces that are inspiring. For example, do you have conference rooms that look tired and dated? Or maybe it's an Employee of the Month wall that nobody even really looks at, or an award wall that looks cluttered and doesn't really tell the story of why you got the award. But what if you had spaces that were transformed to look like this? And what if they inspired not only you, but your team, clients, and better yet, potential clients to want to do business with you and come join your team? And what if, where it was important, components were updatable so you keep your spaces engaging and fresh? For example, if you're pitching to build a new hospital, these shelves can speak to how many healthcare projects you've done. And instead of a How to Keep Up Employee of the Month Wall, these project boards can speak to some of your most impressive healthcare projects, and then celebrate the team that worked on the project. You don't want a small, little dated plaque that has your mission statement on it. You want your space to scream what makes you fantastic to work for and with. And you want to celebrate your history and tell your story. And you want to be an example and inspire others to make a difference in the community. By showing off your team's latest contributions, these triangles and rectangles have magnet backers and can easily be updated. You want your team to know how important it is to reduce the company's carbon footprint, and that the lunch chairs they're sitting in are made from recycled Coke bottles. You want your elevator lobbies to be memorable, and your first impression to be inviting and welcoming. Making your environment engaging and inspiring only translates into more sales and being a magnet for the best talent. So now that I've explained our why and what gets us jazzed to come to work every day, let me share with you why you might want to join our team. First of all, it's a blast to be around people that create environments that create great experiences, and we're passionate about what we do. In a nutshell, we all share this vision, and we like to be around each other. We truly enjoy each other's company and our various perspectives. At CSB, that's what we call ourselves. We're truly interested in your ideas, and we'll help you implement them to make us better. We even have a Bright Idea contest every year, and the winner receives 48,000 Southwest Airlines points and 2 additional days off. We're essential. You can't open a building without us. We have a family atmosphere, but a big corporate benefit package, and we offer things like a salary and hourly pay that's commensurate with your experience, annual bonuses based on the performance of the company as a whole, and then these are photos of team members that received their 10-year anniversary checks of $10,000. CSB pays for 70% of the cost of your health, dental, and eye insurance. We have paid vacation and paid holidays. We have 100% 401k match contribution, and you're fully vested in a year. Our projects are really varied, and so there's never a dull day, and our customers love our work. We're growing, so we have positions in all areas of our business. Design, whether that be entry or advanced levels, installation, finishing, quality control, estimating, project management. So if CSB sounds like a place you want to call home, then text hire me to 33777. We'll get your email and send out a link for the positions you're interested in. Again, simply text hire me to 33777 and we'll start the process. We're so looking forward to meeting you.
And I can stand for questions.
Roxana, thank you so much. Can you tell us what positions you are hiring for?
Sure. I'm also putting the text in the chat. Let me finish. So we are growing. That went to the panelists, and I probably need that to go to everybody. So one of the questions is, do we only hire in the Albuquerque area? No, actually, different positions, some of them you can actually work remotely. Say, for instance, our estimating position, some of them are in fabrication, and we our headquarters is here in Albuquerque, but we have a clientele that is worldwide. So our installers sometimes travel to New York City and California and all around. And so it's not just the Albuquerque area. Okay, thanks Earl for putting that in there. Sure, project management type, what's needed. So we are a subcontractor to general contractors, as well as we work directly with clients. So oftentimes we will be part of a big project. Like right now we're working on the Phoenix Airport, or it might be we're working at UNMH or Presbyterian and working on all the signage, either for a large campus or an actual building or buildings. And so the project manager is usually managing a team of an artist and also a production artist. So they're working with a general contractor to figure out the scope of our work. It's already usually been estimated, or they might be part of the estimating. But basically, I would call our project managers the herder of cats. So you are starting with the end in mind. You know, the end in mind looks like, hey, the customer's happy, we can help people find their way. And then backing into what that takes. So it's going to take a lot of organization skills, a lot of negotiating skills, the ability to simplify complex things, and also lead a team of artists to get submittals done and then get it finally into production, coordinating their install with our installability. So I hope that answers that question. Finance and contract management. So one of the questions is, where would finance and contract management maybe come into our process? We have the need for estimators, and also we have the need for someone to what I call systemize. So we're right now at about 4.2 million. We plan to grow to about 10 million. So a lot of the things we do are more mom and pop. Or, you know, more advanced maybe than mom and pop, but we need to systemize a lot of the things we do. So we are looking for someone that's got great systemizing skills, like is very familiar with various kinds of software and how we might bring that together. Hopefully that, so again, it's, even if you want to consider or keep the conversation going, go ahead and text to that 33777 number, hire me, all one word, and at least we'll get your email and we can continue on the conversation, because we are just growing leaps and bounds and we really need good people, whether that's part-time or full-time. So we do have part-time, like a customer service rep. You know, we have lots of large clients that once we've done their facility, so once we've done a hospital, they're going to have many, many needs after that. So whether you're really organized as an admin person or whether you are really good at graphic design, we have places. and we also, I want to talk a little bit about the finishing position. It's kind of our last person in production that looks at the work order. And we have, our work orders are pay, like for instance, a hospital might have 875 sign types in it. So it gets rather complex. So it's somebody that really is checking the work order before it goes out the door to either be installed or shipped. So we have a big need there as well. Liliana, is there any, I don't see anything else.
Yeah, we have four questions in the Q&A. So the next question is, do you have positions for engineers with a PhD degree? I'm sorry.
No, not specifically, meaning it's not necessary to have an engineering degree. I think an engineering degree always speaks to kind of a variety of things that we can use. For example, we have all of our submittals are engineered by a professional engineer that tells us, yeah, that design is gonna work. Because we're different than most designers, maybe that will design something and you know, you don't really care whether it gets made or not. ours are going to get made, and they have to withstand a wind load, a variety of things. So that ability to take a design and actually make it happen in the real world is huge for our project management. So I could see that the skill sets for engineering could easily translate into some of the things we need. But we don't have an engineering faction. So we go out to professionals to do that in the markets where they have licenses. But I think that skill set is a great skill set, whether it's for project and, you know, project management or estimating.
Thank you. The next question is, what experience would an estimator need?
I would say at least the having been in the construction industry, or in certainly in the signage industry is great. Not a lot of people have that, but we do live in a construction industry a lot, even if we're direct to the client. So the ability to read a set of plans, the ability to operate in software like Bluebeam or even Revit is great. All of those can be trained. So, but I would say definitely, you know, some construction background, having been in construction, watching buildings or campuses be built, you know, and being a part of that process. Certainly that process has a lot of specialized paperwork that general contractors require us to fill out.
Hi, Roxana. This is Stuart. Do you ever hire environmental engineers?
Again, no, not with the specific goal of having, we don't have enough business where that would be required for that skill set of environmental, meaning we're checking and looking at soil, you know, complexity and that kind of thing. So we don't do that. If we need someone, we'll hire that out. It's not a full-time job, but I think any skill set, like my dad was a civil engineer, any skill set you have when you're an engineer, I think if you really want to be a part of us, you first have to kind of look and see whether our why, which is, you know, we build environments that create great experiences. And if that jazzes you, then I think that skill set could transfer, if that makes sense, Stuart. So it's really whether you could wrap your head around being passionate about what we're passionate about. So we accomplish that, like I said, basically in two ways. One, really good, efficient signage. You know, you need to get to the emergency room. We have signage that, you know, we've thought through what the message is and how it's going to get there. So if you are logical in that way and it makes sense, it's a good wayfinding kind of thought process. And then the second way is our more creative, like the video showed you, of where we take offices and we will, or interior or exterior space, and say, wow, what would we do if we wanted to really tell this company's story? You know, what would make you jazz to want to be there? You know, what would really make your day? You know, what would make that engaging, that environment? So it's those two ways that we do that.
Thank you, Roxana.
Thank you, Stuart.
Definitely has a, your company definitely has a ring of a scope of work that a lot of us don't necessarily think about all the time. I guess a lot of us still think of the sign shop that might be in a shopping center or something like that. The scope of your work is very interesting work.
Yeah, it's, you know, that one slide where we talked about it's never a dull day. I mean, we get like I had never been in a morgue, right? Why would I ever be in a morgue, right? Well, we did the tri-labs and it's fascinating, creepy, but fascinating. So we get all sorts of, you know, we did the Ritz-Carlton in Puerto Rico. You know, my whole team flew to Puerto Rico. Our projects are very varied. I explain it to people, you know, kind of like you said, the sign shop that's in the retail area, we are not that. In fact, I usually tell people that call us, you know, we can make a banner, we just don't. You know, we have the huge facility. We have about 20,000 square feet here in Albuquerque. But what we specialize in is large campuses, large entities that need our help, either in creating a sign standard. Okay, so we helped El Paso, UTEP, all of their exterior signs. We worked with them to implement all of that. So once a company has a sign standard, then their facility managers are able to incorporate that. But it takes about a year for us to even, on a large entity, come up with what the signage should say, because everything changes. So you have to be able to change it, and you have to be able to change it from afar if you want to go global.
All right, I was just checking one more time. And one quick question is the only way to apply via text?
That's the best way. Funny, because until I did this, I hadn't thought through what's the best way for me to capture this really quick. So we're gonna send you a link, and you can say, hey, you know, I don't even know what I don't know, but I want to share my talents with you, and just text us that. And then we'll send you a link, but it captures, and you can add your resume, you can add your portfolio, you can add your website, any of that. But it walks through a series of questions that helps us get to know you and where we might be able to apply your talents best. So that's kind of my central location, and it won't get lost. They come directly to me.
Just to follow on with that, can they go to your website and be able to apply online there as well?
Yes. If you go to our website, which my crew is fast working on that because we had to put the video together so fast. If you go to our website, and our website's really fun anyway, so it would show you all our projects, or not all of them, but a lot of them. And then over, there's two buttons that are kind of fun to look at. There's one button that says all the cool stuff, because I couldn't figure out a way to just dump really cool pictures. So I thought, well, we're just gonna call it all the cool stuff we've done. And that's really fun to look at, and you'll see the variety of stuff we do. And then the second, the next button, the very last button, says join our team. And it talks about our vision and that kind of thing. And then down below, it'll have apply. And there's one that just says, I've got talent. And it's the same process that we would give you if you text hire me to that number.
Very good. I've gone ahead and put your
website
website on the chat link. And right now, all panelists and attendees can see that. So if they'd like to.
Okay, great. Thanks, sir.
All right. Do we have any more questions right now? If not, thank you so much, Roxanna. Very interesting.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thanks to Liliana and Earl and Stuart. Thanks for having us. We really appreciate the opportunity. And like I said, we are growing and really need good people, and we would love to meet you. So thanks so much.
NORC is many things.
Social science in the public interest.
Groundbreaking research.
Great people.
Enthusiastic.
Gives me the possibility to touch lives.
We really made a contribution to the public knowledge.
We push the boundaries of data collection.
We analyze data and turn into useful knowledge decision makers can use.
High quality information.
Working together towards a common goal in different areas of expertise to make science really good.
Hi, I'm Dan Galen, President and CEO of NORC at the University of Chicago, an objective nonpartisan research institution. We help governments, nonprofits, and businesses make better decisions through reliable data and rigorous analysis. Over the next few minutes, you'll learn a little bit more about NORC's work, its dedicated and talented people, and the core values that drive us.
Since 1941, NORC has conducted groundbreaking studies, created innovative research tools and methodologies, and advanced principles of scientific integrity and collaboration. Today, government, corporate, and nonprofit clients around the world partner with NORC to transform increasingly complex information into useful knowledge. We maintain primary offices in Chicago and the DC metro area and multiple regional offices across the country. The NORC community consists of cross-departmental teams of researchers, statisticians, data scientists, survey methodologists, information designers, IT specialists, financial analysts, and other professionals, all working together to ensure we provide our partners and clients with the most meaningful insights. Over its 75-plus years, NORC has studied a wide range of important issues facing society, but our work can best be described in five main research areas that include economics, markets, and the workforce. Education, training, and learning. Global development. Health and well-being. Society, media, and public affairs.
Work we do is so important because health, it just impacts everyone.
We cover topics like criminal justice, transportation, energy, poverty, housing, and the labor pool. We do a great service to our nation in providing data that can be used to inform the policies that we make.
Our goal is to make sure that Americans' voices are measured well, with a high degree of quality, and interjected into the policy conversation.
No matter what field of inquiry we are examining, NORC is rooted in a fascination for what comes next. But even as our methods and approaches evolve, our core values of excellence, innovation, and collegiality remain the same.
We put a premium on doing high-quality research, and that's what we're known for.
When I go to sleep at night, I know the work that I do is true.
Innovation is really the heart and soul of all aspects of the work we do here at NORC.
A place where I feel innovation is appreciated.
NORC supports my innovation by really encouraging my collaborations with faculty here at the University of Chicago and with other staff across the company.
My favorite part of my job has to be the people.
People are open about what they do and helping one another solve problems.
Everybody's ideas count at NORC, from the junior staff to very senior staff.
A core mission to really develop staff and to help people develop their careers.
It's a great place for personal growth.
Society increasingly depends on objective data and rigorous analysis to make its most important decisions. All of us here at NORC are committed to helping our clients meet the exciting challenges ahead and benefit from emerging opportunities.
I've worked here for a little over 2 years.
Exactly 3 years.
Almost 4 years.
6 years.
7 years.
Almost 9 years.
14 and a half years.
17 years.
For 19 years.
20 years now. And I've never really thought about going somewhere else. It's been the place for me.
I invite you to learn more about NORC and our mission to illuminate the world around us. Thanks for your time today.
And now I'd like to introduce Tasi Rodriguez and Natasha Ogin with NORC at the University of Chicago.
Thank you, Stuart. So I'm gonna go ahead and share my screen. Okay, so I am Tassie Rodriguez, and I am the assistant HR manager here in the Albuquerque office. We also have Natasha Olguin, who is the HR rep here in Albuquerque. We'll be running through a little bit more about the projects that we have here at NORC, and then Natasha will go into the position that we're currently hiring for. In addition to that, we will also be covering the benefits for that position, as well as our response to COVID and any next steps in case you're interested in applying with us. So NORC at the University of Chicago is an objective, nonpartisan research organization that delivers insights and analysis decision makers trust. We have main offices in our downtown Chicago and University of Chicago campus, as well as the DC Metro. And we have regional offices across the United States, Albuquerque, Atlanta, Boston, Sacramento, Silicon Valley, and in Wichita. We have three main call centers that we are hiring for. We have in Albuquerque, Wichita, and Chicago. We have over 400 active research projects at any given moment. We have over 3,000 staff members. We do over $200 million annual in revenue on various research projects, and we have worked in over 85 countries. Since 1941, we have been a driving force in a lot of the social science research innovation, improving quality, lowering costs for research, and opening up new areas of inquiry. These are some of our major projects. Amerispeak, we do work with the Associated Press. GSS is also a very popular research project that we have. A lot of the data that we're quoted in the media from time to time typically comes from either Amerispeak or GSS. And we also do Medicare Current Beneficiary Survey. So MCBS is another continuous yearly project that we have. We also have the National Survey of Early Education and Early Care. And we have the National Social Life Health and Aging Project, as well as a survey of consumer finances. These are some of our larger projects. We do have boutique projects that we work on as well, some smaller projects with a variety of different topics. So the position that we're hiring for, the telephone interviewer position, is a critical position within our organization. They are the ones that actually gather all of the data that we have within these specific research projects. Okay, so now Natasha will be sharing about the telephone interviewer position.
Hi guys, so again, I'm the HR rep at the Albuquerque location here. So just some information about the telephone interviewer position. The first thing that we want you to know is not a sales position, so there's no sales calls. What it is just our interviewers reaching out to respondents over the phone to get through surveys with them. So it's a lot of outbound calls. And then sometimes there is the occasional inbound calls if you are working our toll-free line. But again, no sales, it's just reaching out and speaking to individuals all across America to get their points of view for the projects that we're working on. In regards to the ideal candidate, what we're looking for is we're looking for someone who appreciates a flexible schedule that fits their lifestyle. So our typical candidates and employees are interviewers from all ages and backgrounds, so diverse work experiences, that sort of thing. The only stipulation that is that we do require our interviewers to be at least 18 years of age, but other than that, it's a very diverse pool. Some examples of our employees include college students who are just looking for a part-time job to complement their class schedules, customer service professionals, just looking to hone in those customer service skills a little bit more with the position, and then teachers or other individuals that are just looking for a part-time opportunity to kind of complement their personal obligations that they already have or other jobs that they may have currently. So what makes a good telephone interviewer? The number one thing is we definitely want someone who enjoys talking with people, right? We're going to be getting their a lot of people's opinions about certain surveys that we're working on. So we are looking for someone that has the ability to be polite, friendly, and professional with speaking with respondents and also coworkers, right? Using correct word pronunciations and not using slangs as we're getting through the surveys, using an expressive and confident voice when conducting surveys, being assertive and yet polite while convincing respondents to participate in survey, which we do provide training on if you feel like you kind of need to practice those skills a little bit more. Administer survey questions word for word while using conversational skills to gain cooperation. Ability to use a computer to enter the survey responses that the telephone interviewers are getting, and understanding that survey refusals are not personal. So that being said, there could be some challenges to the position that could be including, you know, as an interviewer, you're sitting down at the computer for your entire shift. So that could be your computer at home, or also if you're working on site, we're sitting at that computer waiting for those inbound calls to talk to those respondents, or waiting for information to reach out to respondents. So it could take up to 10 minutes waiting for information to reach out to another respondent. During that time, we expect, you know, our employees to be professional. So conversations are at a minimal and work related. And, you know, also too, as well, we don't condone cell phones usage during, you know, work time. And also too, as well, just because, you know, if we're waiting for that, or, you know, it can be repetitive, it can be mundane when not speaking with respondents. So even though it may be challenging, however, you're taught strategies for interacting and engaging with people. So that's included as part of training. So in regards to the work schedule for the telephone interviewer position, we're looking for someone who can work a minimum of 24 hours per week. That includes morning, evening, and weekend shifts as well. Our requirements is that an interviewer must be able to work one shift until 8 p.m., sometime between Sunday and Thursday, and a 6-hour shift on Friday or Saturday. Other than that, it's a pretty flexible schedule. It's your needs and the business needs combined, and it just kind of depends on the project that you're working on. Also, what this includes is that, again, I've kind of mentioned this, you do have the ability to work from home as well as work on site. We do have criteria set for individuals working from home, which you can learn more about in your interview, okay? So when interviewers first start with us, we do require that all interviewers, regardless if they may be work from home or work on site, that they do complete our required on-site training. Interviewers will be paid for that training. The typical schedule for new hire training is going to start on a Friday evening typically, will be Saturday, and then the second week of training starting up on Monday through Thursday. The exact training dates and times are provided at the time of hire. This is just our typical schedule. And then after training, an interviewer's first shift typically starts 1 to 2 days after completion of training. So getting into the benefits about the position, the first thing that we want to talk about is the pay. So telephone interviewers that are conducting English surveys, we're looking at $14 per hour. That is a combined rate of a $11 an hour base rate plus a $3 COVID premium. And those conducting Spanish surveys are looking at $14.50 an hour to start at. With the COVID premium, we've had that for the past year. Just as an FYI, if there are any changes, which at this point in time, we haven't heard of any, interviewers will get a 4-week notice, just as FYI there. Other benefits of being a telephone interviewer, opportunity for promotion and increases in pay within the first 9 months. Interviewers also have the opportunity to contribute to our retirement plan with TIA or TIAA, and also they could be eligible for an employer contribution. We do have an employee assistance program. This is a free, openly available resource to employees and their dependents for a range of issues from, you know, mental health to maybe, you know, looking for affordable childcare in the area, right? Again, we do have paid new hire training, and anytime new projects come up, any training required for that, we do provide to our employees, and also work breaks. We do have incentives for our top performers every month. And also we do have a referral bonus. So, you know, referring family and friends to work with you here at NORC, we're always looking for great talent. And so employees can get up to $500 per referral, depending on the criteria there. And also we do have casual dress and a friendly work environment. We do want individuals to be comfortable working on site here with us. And so definitely you can come in jeans and a t-shirt, and that's perfectly fine. So safety protocols in regards to COVID, there's a number of things that we're doing. even with the new CDC guidelines, we are sticking to our protocols currently right now. That does include that for every individual that comes on site, they get their temperature checked. They're asked a series of screening questions to make sure they're not having any symptoms or that they've been exposed to anyone who has symptoms, and also that they haven't traveled within the last 14 days. If someone, if that applies to them where they are having symptoms or they have a high temperature, at that point, they're not allowed on site, just to make sure that everyone is safe, right? Also too, as well, we do have plexiglass installed throughout the whole site at the desk. So for that extra protection, masks are required. We also have Clorox wipes provided for disinfecting, your workstation. This has always been the case for Norick, but we've just kind of upped that with COVID. Employees are also issued their own headset and job aid, so it's not anything about sharing materials. We have our 6 feet social distancing being enforced, and that we have signage all across the site as a reminder of what we expect with these protocols. And also all new hires do receive a presentation on our safety protocol to kind of introduce them to that as well. So now that we've kind of talked about that, what is the next steps with our hiring process? The next step is going to be to apply for the position. We're looking for about 100 telephone interviewers currently. The way that you can apply is going to our website. It's in orange at the bottom here, and it's been at the bottom of all of our slides. That's going to be work.matters.norick.org. When you get to that page on the right-hand side, you'll see view all current TSSO job opportunities. You'll click on that. It'll take you to our page where you can see the positions open for Albuquerque. So you'll apply there. Definitely be sure to check your email frequently after putting in that application, just because our communications are going to be via email. Also, interviews are being conducted weekly over the phone, so that's another big reason to keep an eye out on email, just because we do move pretty quickly. So if you do get an invitation to interview, that's going to be in your email there. Training classes are being held weekly as well, so we're looking for a quick turnaround time if you are selected to join us. And we do suggest preparing your I-9 documentation in the meantime, just because as a federal contractor, we do require that all employees have their I-9 documentation within 3 days of hire to be able to join us. We also at this point wanted to take a minute to share a little bit more info about another position that we just recently opened up. So on our website, you'll also see that we have the position for team lead open. That's kind of like the entry level position that steps into the realm of coaching or, managing telephone interviewers. So if you're an individual that says, hey, I have these great customer service skills and I'm ready to take it to the next level. And at that point, we would suggest taking a look at the team lead position as well. Just some other additional info about that. It does start at $17.75 an hour. That's a $14.75 base rate and that $3 COVID premium added to that. So if that's something that you're interested or if you're interested in both, please feel free to apply. But we just wanted to make sure that you guys were aware of that information too as well, just because that's recently new. Alrighty, so again, if you would like to apply for either the telephone interviewer or team lead position, we welcome you to go to work.matters.norick.org to put in that application. Also, feel free to follow us on Facebook. We have a lot of updates regarding what we're doing on site, our interactions with the community on there as well. So feel free to take a look. And then also too, if you have any additional questions, you can call our site at 505-389-4400. And again, we do remind you that to keep an eye out for emails, just because that's the way that we primarily communicate with our candidates.
And at this time, we would like to share a quick video in regards to our telephone interviewer position and how you can take that into a career of your own, if that is something that you are interested in.
And just as an FYI, this is the individual that will be talking this video. It's actually our senior production manager, so our site manager here in Albuquerque. And it details his journey from starting as a telephone interviewer to becoming a site manager.
My name is Eric Lopez. I'm a senior production manager and site operations center manager in our Albuquerque operations center. The way I joined NORC was I had a family member that I actually worked at NORC. They told me about the interviewer position, which they were hiring for, and I found it very intriguing, specifically with the projects that they were doing. So I applied and I got hired, thankfully. Well, my background 18 years ago was really going into college and potentially going into law school, but that really changed when I started working at NORC, for the better, I would say. The reason I stayed with NORC and worked my way up was that it was very meaningful work. A lot of the surveys that we were doing and projects that we were working on were really to help the communities, to learn what people were feeling. Back in 9/11, we actually did a survey that was really gauging how people were feeling during that time. And that sort of work, doesn't come often, and I felt that it was very meaningful. The positions I held at NORC started off as an interviewer, a bilingual interviewer at that, doing English and Spanish interviews back when we had a site in Downers Grove. From there, I became a supervisor. I then became an assistant production manager when that position actually was created. Then a few years after that, I became a production manager and then a site operations center manager in Albuquerque, which was a great opportunity for me. And then a couple years after that, I became a senior production manager. For the new telephone interviewers, I'd say first to, hang in there. There's a learning curve in that position. And, I had it myself when I first started as an interviewer. But I've been very, very happy that I hung in there and listened to the advice I was getting from my supervisors and the people around me. I would say that there's always a lot of opportunities for them, as there were for me. We love to hire within. Being able to do that means that people have that experience and understand what the work that we're doing means. The way I would describe my job at NORC is rewarding. There is a lot of work that goes into it, but it pays off knowing that you put all the effort into it, that there is a lot of rewards coming out of it in the way of that the work that you did was meaningful. Sometimes you could see it on the news and you can say, hey, I was part of that work.
Well, thank you so much for your time today. If there's any questions, we could address those now.
Thank you so much. Yep, we've got a real quick question here. Do you have part-time positions?
Yeah, so the telephone interviewer position is a part-time position. We're looking at individuals that can work a minimum of 24 hours. It's about 24 to 28 hours per week.
Sounds good. Mm-hmm. Here's somebody that definitely has finances on the mind. Can you give more details about referral bonuses?
Sure, absolutely. So for our referral bonus for an employee that refers their family or friend to work with us, if they are hired as a bilingual telephone interviewer, the employee has the opportunity of receiving a referral bonus of $500. And of course, that's minus applicable taxes, right? We look at a couple of things for the referral bonus. We look at their attendance, however, for that new hire. And we also look at increment. So it's really $500 after 56 days of employment. If they're not bilingual interviewers, then at that point it's $100 or $200 total at the 56 day mark, as long as they meet the criteria, which is always discussed in our new hire orientation.
Very good. What are the average lengths of a shift? Is 4 hours too short?
Nope. Definitely 4 hours is a possible shift length that someone could have. Again, scheduling is dependent upon the business needs and also the needs of the employees, that kind of combined, that kind of collaboration there. So definitely it could be possible that someone could have a 4 hour shift. We just got to make sure that we're meeting that minimum hour requirement of 24 per week.
All right. We've got another question here, and this is regarding the team lead position. When will the training begin for that position?
Tassie, do you want to take that one?
Sure. We are anticipating having that job posting open for 2 to 3 weeks. We just recently opened it at the end of last week. So once we get through that period, we'll conduct interviews. And then it should start pretty quickly after a week or two of those interview sessions.
Very good. I have another question here. Can you please talk more about work from home opportunity?
Yeah, absolutely. So for individuals that are coming on board with us, they do have the opportunity to work from home. We do ask that they meet our criteria, which is can include that you have a quiet space to work, right? That you have your own cell phone to be able to take the calls. However, NORC does provide the rest of the equipment, so like the laptop and stuff like that we provide. So we just need for the interviewer to have a phone that they're able to take calls uninterrupted with. Also, we do have internet requirements. So we're looking at an individual that has 10 megabytes per second internet capabilities for downloads and then 5 megabits per second for upload capabilities. If an individual isn't sure about what their internet speeds look like or whether they meet that criteria for that speed, I would just reach out to the internet provider. They'll be able to provide more information about that. And again, also too, as well, working the 24 hours per week.
Very good. About how many hours a day is the training for interviewers?
So when we get into the required new hire training for interviewers, what we're looking at is the typical schedule is that on Friday, we're looking at 4 p.m. to 10 p.m. And then Saturday would be 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Sunday is a break there. And then from Monday through Thursday of that following week, we're looking at a typical schedule of 4 p.m. to 10 p.m. So we're looking at about 6 hours or so less minus breaks.
Very good. I believe that's all the questions we have for right this second. Remember, attendees, if you happen to think of a question, just make sure you get it to us and we will get it to the appropriate company. If there aren't any more questions right now, Tassie and Natasha, we appreciated your individual insight and input. Very interesting work, definitely a different type of call center environment, call center work. And we appreciate you.
Thank you so much. Likewise, Stuart.
Oh, we got one more quick question. How long after training can you work from home?
As long as we meet the criteria, it's our goal that we're able to get interviewers working from home right after training. So after that completion of on-site training, hopefully towards the end, we're looking at getting them all set up to work from home, and then that their first shift is actually after training is actually work from home.
Great. Well, again, we appreciate you being here and being part of this career connection, and we hope to see you again.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.
At this time, it's my pleasure to introduce Shelley Barat, HR manager, and Sintel Renteria, software engineer with BroadSpot Imaging.
Let's just start with. Hi, everybody.
Hi.
I'm Shelley Barat, and this is Sintel Renteria, and we are with BroadSpot Imaging Corporation. And we're just going to talk to you a little bit about what we do and what we're looking for. We're actually a new company in the state. We've relocated from Northern California, and we are just kind of in a new startup mode here in Albuquerque. So I'll go ahead and get started and share the screen here with you. Take over here for a minute. So as I mentioned, the company BroadSpot Imaging has been around, and what we do is we make ophthalmic imaging devices. And the company started in Northern California, and they have come up with a great prototype that we are now taking as a kind of startup mode here in Albuquerque towards a FDA 510K approval process for any sort of medical device, and also manufacturing and commercialization. So that's who we are. And our imaging device is a low-cost, portable, wide-field retinal camera. And it's actually handheld, and it's going to pioneer with machine learning applications of retinal imaging in systemic disease. So we have a single hardware platform. And what that can do is support a growing catalog of clinical diagnostics, which is key to healthcare AI. So you can see where this is going. It's kind of a complex situation. There's lots and lots of potential here. So this is a picture of a couple of the devices. The one that we have now is called the Horizon. And Sintel can tell you a little bit more about it, but it's basically, like I said, a handheld device that can take a photo of a person's retina. And so it's got the ultra wide field of view. It's portable, handheld, and low cost. So having a hardware as a service really is going to help create our revenue stream. So we're a pre-revenue company, but we are venture backed. So when we do go forward with our hardware as a service, we start to collect a lot of images. And so we're going to have these retinal diagnostic models that we're going to start looking into for biomarkers for certain systemic diseases. Pretty interesting stuff. Oh, that picture back there is actually the unit in its little case. So we think we have a really good story here. We think the market is really ripe for several iterations of what we're doing. Again, starting with that device, going into automated diagnosis, and then AI into the larger healthcare market for adults as well as newborns. So our business structure is, like I said, we're pre-revenue, we're venture funded. We've got a solid prototype that we're working with, and we own our own technology. So that's really the important part of how the business has been up until now. We are now kind of taking our own technology, and we're going to manufacture it and commercialize it once we get through the FDA approvals and that sort of a thing. So we are now hiring to help us get through that. So here's a little trajectory of our evolution. We've gotten to the point where we actually have optics, hardware, and software on board. We are beginning our strategy and initial clinical trials right now as we speak. We're going to soon be on the finalization of that and get the FDA certification so that we can start manufacturing and getting into the commercial aspect of that. So here we are, you know, about to do some hiring on that front. So we are looking for teammates to help us build and eat pizza. So this is kind of a list of some of the positions we're hiring for. They're very heavy on technical and engineering. So as high up as a VP of engineering, optical engineer, definitely optics is key. We're looking for some really good software engineers, including a senior software engineer, a software engineer one. Sintel can talk a little bit more about the software engineering and technical aspect of things, manufacturing engineer, mechanical, maybe a mechanical tech, and some associates down the road here, a purchasing agent, quality engineer. So again, heavy on that technical part of things. And here's just some of the things that we work with. You can kind of look through the list, but obviously optics, because we're talking about an imaging device, software development, firmware, that sort of a thing. So I'm going to let Sintel talk just a little bit about the technical aspect and kind of what it's like to work here. And then I'll get a little bit more into the culture and some of our benefits and that sort of a thing. But I thought that for those who are on here that might be technical or interested in technical, take a bite out of what Sintel is going to talk about, because there are folks that can do software development that are alternative. Some of the positions do require a bachelor's or even, you know, higher up if needed, if it's a specialized situation, but some do not. And certain pieces of knowledge and boot camps are very relevant. So I'm going to let Sintel talk to you a little bit.
Hi, everyone. So again, I'm Sintel, and I'm a software engineer here at BroadSpot. And I guess just to give a little bit of a background, this is my first job as a software engineer. And it's also my first position at like a true startup. And working here has been incredibly rewarding so far. Just like a really positive, supportive environment. And I actually come from a non-tech background, but I sort of transitioned into programming through taking two coding boot camps. One was here in Albuquerque. It's through Deep Dive Coding. And in that boot camp, I learned about embedded programming. And that is sort of what gave me the kind of solid foundation to build on in this position. It's through CNM Ingenuity. And feel free to ask me any questions on that. I can give contact information and all. So I have that kind of like solid foundation from that boot camp for this position specifically. And some of the programming languages that I use here are C++, Python, and some Bash scripting. I guess some of the tasks that I've kind of been working on are adding like new features to our main application, which is lives on the actual handheld device, as well as adding a few features to like our user interface application. And I've just started kind of gotten into writing some automation scripts to kind of refine some of our processes. And there's a lot of kind of flexibility with the software here. You kind of dip your hands into a lot of the different kind of like tools that we use, developmental tools and platforms. And yeah, I've learned so much. If there's anything in particular that you guys have questions on, I'd be happy to answer.
Thanks, Sintel. We're going to take a little breather. Liliana, does anyone have any questions so far? Earl? Okay, I'm going to keep going then. So in addition to some of the cool tech stuff, and she's one aspect of it, we also have 3D modeling, 3D printing, and then as we go deeper, we'll get into that machine learning and AI. And so we definitely, if anyone has that in their foresights, let us know. Like I mentioned, we are very much embarking on this FDA 510K process. So if you have experience with medical devices and that sort of thing, we'd love to hear from you. Medical industry standards for devices, validation and verification experience. So those are just some of the techie things that we've got.
We're just kind
Well, as you can see, every now and then there is a little bit of a freeze factor, and we're trying to take care of this technical glitch right at this moment. If you have any questions regarding BroadSpot Imaging, please make sure you put it in the Q&A, and we should be back up and running.
We're back up and running. I'm getting that PowerPoint back on. Thanks for your patience. Even technical companies have their glitches every now and then. So we just got to go with the flow is what that's all about. So
I'm assuming that the more Zooms hit the airways, there'll be more issues that we're going to have to be involved in. But we're doing great so far.
That's great. Appreciate it. So that's the key, is you just got to keep going with the flow. So we are, it's a great segue. Our culture is, highly collaborative, cross-functional. We're really looking for that sort of versatility, flexibility in our employees. We like to have fun, but we have a serious focus as well, and lots of problem solving, just like we just did. Sintel was bringing up the whole Zoom thing on her laptop as well, just in case as a backup. So, we've got things that we can do quickly to problem solve, but obviously innovation, because we're a fairly new company. We've got lots of things, still in the background that are waiting for these innovative minds to come in and help us develop. We definitely are an inclusive company. And we value creativity and whatever it is that we're doing. So that's kind of a thing with the culture here. I can't stress enough the highly collaborative and communicative as well. So again, we're a startup. We're pretty upbeat. We're focused on team effort and quality. We have many means of communication. We use Slack and Zoom and that sort of a thing. Although here in the near future and our hires between now and the next 4 to 6 months are probably all going to be in the same place. So there's really not going to be distance learning at that point, distance working, just because, pandemic things are, people are getting their vaccines. So that's good. And we can all work together again, which is great. So we do have very supportive management. We try to be as transparent as possible with all of our employees and with each other, and we're an all hands company. So some of our benefits, we offer PTO, really great medical, dental, vision, 401k, incentive stock options, and of course, high wage engineering positions. We do have a referral bonus as well. I didn't put the details of it up here, but we do have one of those. So that kind of gives you an idea of our benefits and culture. It's just a really upbeat and I think progressive company. So how to apply, you're going to want to probably visit our website. Again, we're sort of new as a startup getting into the world now that we have the prototype, which is what really the company has done, through their living in California. And now we're taking what they've done and gonna manufacture it, commercialize it. So we have a little bit of information on our website, but we're gonna grow from there. But there is a jobs page, and you can attach a resume and cover letter there, or you can email a resume and cover letter to jobs@broadspotimaging.com. So again, my name is Shelley Barrett, and there's Sintel again, and we are happy to take your questions.
Well, the first question that we have right now is, if you wouldn't mind, please repeat the positions that you're currently hiring for.
Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and go back to that page right here. It's our build and pizza page. So we are looking for, software engineers, we really are looking for a senior software engineer, somebody who's real experienced and has worked several companies putting together things maybe similar to what we're doing. Software engineer, one. So maybe you've taken some boot camps like Centel has done, manufacturing engineer, because we're going to start that process, mechanical engineer and a mechanical tech, who maybe somebody who doesn't have that mechanical engineering degree, but has some work experience that's, you know, pretty heavy on mechanical and SolidWorks and maybe some 3D imaging and things like that. Electrical engineer, optical engineer. I know that's a very specialized one, but we definitely are looking for someone who can work with some of these small scale optics and help guide us in that direction, especially with some of the things we have in the pipeline. Manufacturing associates, we may be looking for a couple of folks that are not engineers, but have some manufacturing experience, especially again with small components. That may be a month or two down the road, but definitely if you have that experience, we want to hear from you. And of course, a quality engineer, and the small chance right now of somebody listening that knows of a great VP of engineering, we're also looking for someone who can come in and help run the show and all the different aspects, hardware, firmware, software, and everything in between. Hopefully that answers that question. And, you know, look, we're in the process of posting these job descriptions. We're going to be posting them on the New Mexico Workforce Solutions website. Not all of them are up there right at this moment, but they will be within the week, and they'll have more information. So don't assume that everything requires a master's degree or bachelor's degree. Take a look at those when they're up, or shoot me a question, jobs@broadspotimaging.com.
Here's a quick question. They're indicating that they'd like to apply for the manufacturing position. I guess that would be the manufacturing associate position. Mm-hmm. And they can still go ahead and send an email with the resume and cover letter to you. Is that correct?
Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. You can either do it by the website or just email me. But it's, you know, we like to have that cover letter because we want to know, you know, what it is about what we're doing that looks curious to you, and kind of a quick summary of your experience if you're looking at that manufacturing associate position. Thank you.
And another one, must have a few manufacturing types that are out there. Regarding the manufacturing associate positions, do you have the specific requirements for that, or at least the ballpark requirements?
We'll post those within the week, and we'll try to get it on the website as well, but they definitely will be on the New Mexico Workforce Solutions jobs website. So within the week, we'll have the specifics about that position.
Another question, do you need a mechanical engineer with a PhD?
You know, we would absolutely love to talk to you. You know, some of these positions they cross over a little bit as folks that have that level of education know well. So definitely please talk to us if you've got that, because there may be some other details that you could get into that won't be listed here. Yes, please. Anything else? Anybody got a interesting question for Centel? Software engineers out there?
At this point in time, I don't think we have any more. We've gone ahead and Liliana put on your website address. And that's on the chat, so any attendees can see www.broadspotimaging.com. And there's plenty of information on that one. I just looked at it.
Great, that's good. You can tell what we do, part of what we do. Thank you.
Sounds very good. Thank you so much for joining us. Really interesting, the kinds of companies that are coming to Albuquerque right now, and you're certainly representative of a great wave of technology, and it's going to be fun growing up some more in New Mexico.
That's right. Yeah. And our CEO, Randy Krall, is here and from here, and is also a serial entrepreneur of several companies throughout this last decade. So we've got some history here, myself as well. I've worked here with some other companies and startups years ago, have been away, but then I returned and was able to start working with Randy. So we're real excited that we're not the only ones, but that there's a wave coming here.
Absolutely. Shelley Sintel, thank you so much for presenting today.
Thank you for having us.
Thanks much.
You know, while we're waiting to get set up again for our next presenter, remember, if you have any questions at all, make sure that you put them in the Q&A spot. And if, for example, you come across an idea or two after a presenter has given their information and you'd like a question or two answered, make sure you get them to us at by calling 843-1900, and we'll be happy to go ahead and forward them on. And now at this time, I'd like to introduce Lorraine Middlebrook, attorney Tony Gertler, Leigh Hansen, and Christina Frazier, all from Freeport McMoRan.
Today we are at Freeport McMoRan in Norwich, and we are going inside to find out what's new in manufacturing and how such a huge field is having a huge impact in the world.
We send our product to a variety of manufacturers that draw copper into anything that you can think of in terms of conducting electricity.
Copper is used in just about, you know, anything you can think of in today's, you know, society, whether it's cell phones, cars, buses.
Well, when I first came here, the work orders were made on paper with carbon paper. Now we have the computers here, so that's one big change. Computers all generate everything we need now. In the machine shop, we have numerical control machines. It's a computerized lathe that we have here, and they fabricate parts that we need.
There have been a lot of changes. There have been a lot more automation, a lot more computers.
A lot of the work is pretty similar to what we were doing back then. We've added a couple of new analytical instruments, but otherwise it's pretty much been the same.
Years ago, when the plant first opened, we didn't have an emission control system. We didn't have a water treatment system to treat the water as it was being discharged.
So I'm in charge of the lab. I'm in charge of ensuring that we have good quality, that all of our product meets specification for the customer before we ship it out.
My job as furnace operator is to take the copper cathodes and melt it down, and I feed the casting operation, which will make continuous cast bar, which we roll into copper rod.
And there are so many jobs in manufacturing, and particularly opportunity within this company. You have engineering jobs, geologist jobs, metallurgist jobs, finance, the whole gambit.
You have the ability to be creative. It's not a boring job. Every day you're doing something different.
Knowing we're making a product that's going to get used by everybody in the world, I think that's kind of neat.
Wow, we definitely learned a lot about the evolution of manufacturing in the copper industry in general.
Yeah, and it's really cool that so many people are working here in their different areas towards the same great goal.
Hi, Lorraine, you have the floor.
All right, thank you. Hi, everyone. My name is Lorraine Middlebrook. I'm one of the site staffing specialists for Freeport-McMoRan. I support our Morenci location in Arizona. So I'm going to share my screen with everybody. And we'll go over a PowerPoint here. So the video that we've seen was specific to our processing side. With Freeport-McMoRan, we do have processing and mining environment. So just to talk a little bit about who we are as a company. We are based in Phoenix, Arizona. We're a global mining company. We mine copper and molybdenum. We do have a global location. So we have locations in North America, South America, Indonesia, and Europe. So specifically for North America, we do have processing and mine sites in Colorado. We also have open pit mines in New Mexico, as well as Arizona. So with our Arizona site, we're going to be talking specifically about our Morenci location. So the town of Morenci is close to the New Mexico border. We do have individuals who live in Lordsburg, and some of our employees commute from Lordsburg to Morenci. So on the map here, you can see where Morenci is at as far as the location. So the town of Morenci, just to give some information about the town, we are one of two company towns. The town itself is known for outdoor activities such as hiking, fishing, camping, and hunting. The town site itself has housing, daycare and community center, healthcare facilities, fitness centers, movie theater, skate park, and restaurants and local businesses as well. So on the line, we also have Lee Hansen and Tony Gertler, who are our supervisor and senior supervisors from the mine maintenance department. So I will pass it over to Lee and to Tony, and that way they can introduce themselves and tell us a little bit more about the process that we have going on for Morenci.
All right. Good morning. My name is Lee Hansen. I am the senior supervisor in mine maintenance here in Morenci. A little bit about me. I'm a mining engineer, and I came to Freeport-McMoRan about 9 years ago. I started out as a reliability engineer, and then I've worked my way up into fleet reliability, and then as a senior supervisor of the tire shop, lube shop, support equipment, and senior supervisor of haulage equipment. Tony?
Hi, my name is Tony Gertler. I started with the company in September of 1999. I started an apprenticeship for heavy equipment in 2002. I worked on heavy equipment here at the truck shop until 2015 when I became a supervisor. And now I'm currently over the fleet ramp monitoring division, and I'm also the hiring manager for the truck shop.
All
You want to go to the next? You want to go to the next slide, Lorraine? So currently, Morenci Mine Maintenance is responsible for care and maintenance of all the equipment. We have 119 haul trucks, 793 Cat haul trucks in our fleet today, and we are ramping up to about 132 by the end of the year. We also have 12 P&H shovels, 12 diesel drills, and we do have an extensive support fleet consisting of 994 loaders. We have two of those. About 30 track dozers of different D10s and D11s. And then we have rubber tire equipment as well, water trucks, some support haul trucks and stuff like that. So we do have an extensive Caterpillar fleet out here.
This is the truck shop here in Morenci. It's a 18 bay truck shop. This is where we work on all the support equipment and haul trucks. There's a lot of work that goes on in and out of this shop. Next slide. These are just the pictures of the engine out of a 793 haul truck. That's a 3516, it's a 16 cylinder engine. Just kind of shows you the magnitude of how big these things are. You could see the guy up under the front bumper right there. He's routing some hoses and stuff probably to get that engine ready to set back in the frame. The picture on your left is an individual torquer to final drive. That's the component that holds the rear duals on the back of this truck. You can see the magnitude, how big those things are. On the right, that's the injectors and valve train on two of the cylinders. It's just a picture of those guys running the valves on the engine while it's in frame. Here on the left, you can see a 994F loader. It's the biggest Caterpillar loader that they make. On the right, that's the biggest motor grader that Caterpillar builds. That's got that's a 24-foot blade on that machine. So it'll blade a lot of road surface. On the left, that's a photo of a part of our PCR program for our dozers. PCR stands for powertrain component replacement. We bring these dozers in and we pretty much strip them down to the frame, redo all the wiring, harnesses, hoses, engines, trannies, and whatever other components are worn out, and we put them back in. We do it typically about every 16,000 hours of use. On the right-hand side is the differential, the third member component out of a haul truck. That's the diff that drives that haul truck. And this is photos of a dipper and a stick off of a 4100 series shovel. And you can see how big that dipper is. It takes approximately three dippers to load a 793 haul truck bed. Those guys started there welded on it. You can see the sheer size and how big those things are.
The bucket, for instance, is a 72-yard bucket, which is at full capacity, hold about 100 tons of material.
This is just more pictures of a welded on the dipper and the clam shells on the ground on the right. That's the that's the door, if you will. Like whenever they grab the muck, that's the piece of the right's what triggers it. It swings open to allow the dirt to come out of the bottom of the bucket.
So some of the opportunities we have here, we do have a large variety of equipment. So there is a very big opportunity to learn different equipment with hands-on. We have very strong mentorships, both mentoring new folks and people that may have some experience coming in, but maybe not on this particular type of equipment. And the whole goal is to make everybody, a good mechanic where they can mentor the next set of workers coming in. So it does have a lot of growth within the company, a lot of growth potential.
Yeah, I go with what Lee said. We actually have multiple ways to come into the heavy equipment world here. We have the DMHs, which is a diesel mechanic helper. And then we have the DREs, which is a repairman level. And then, of course, your DDMs, which is a journeyman skilled trade level. And, all those positions, no matter which one you come into, there's always room to grow, always room to move up.
Yeah. And the other thing that we do offer is our apprenticeships, which I know Tony mentioned that as part of his career development. We do have a robust apprenticeship program where you come in and you go through the apprenticeship of classroom and a hands-on work. And at the end of the program, when we graduate, you'll become a DDM or a journeyman level mechanic.
Now, one thing with the apprenticeship program too, that's a really cool thing is if you get selected to be into one of our apprenticeships, you actually get a pretty nice tool set, whole toolbox tool set and everything. The company pretty much gives that to you for joining the apprenticeship program. So it's a pretty cool opportunity. We also have a very diverse training department that we have. It's company owned, and the guys get to go hands-on with electrical components and hydraulic components in a training environment to help them learn and grow before they actually get on the equipment.
And so this is a screenshot of showing the sensors on the truck. We have what we call RAMP. Which is a remote access monitoring program, where all these trucks are and our shovels are monitored 24 hours a day, every day of the week, by folks down in their command center, and they're at one time mechanics, and now they're down there. When alarms come in off the trucks, they get notified of the alarm. They look up the alarm, see what the potential causes are, and make determinations on the maintenance protocols, whether it needs to be fixed immediately or if it's something we schedule in or something we need to add to our preventative maintenance when it comes around for the PM. So the screen on the left is basically an overview of all the different sensors they can look at, and it's a kind of a quick check on to see what the system of the truck is doing. And then if they can drill down deeper into that by clicking on each one of those boxes and get more information on that particular component that's being monitored. And on the right, that's kind of the deeper dive, is looking at this, the steering pressures on where the haul truck says is going down the road. And they can go back in time and see what it's been doing over days, weeks, and months to develop trends.
Yeah, this is the department that I'm over. This is the fleet monitoring department. And, it works for everything. I mean, if the truck's having problems, they can look it up. But if the truck gets into an accident with another truck, we can actually break down all the data, read different things like suspension pressures and such, and tell exactly when that truck impacted. I could tell you if the it lost engine oil pressure, how long that engine ran. We could just monitor all the vitals, and I could pretty much tell you exactly what we need to do when it comes to the shop.
Yeah, these haul trucks are every bit as sophisticated as any vehicle out there on the road, or more so. Next slide, Ernie. So this is another map that we produce that comes off of our information from our haul trucks. We call it the haul truck travel analytics. That we're using this technology not only for the health of our equipment, but we're also using it for the health of our mind. So the map shows our road system, and the different colors on the map are different road conditions. So we're using, they have an accelerometer in the truck that records different motions or fast motions, and they've been able to correlate that with bad spots in the road. And so every truck that passes over a spot, if it has an event of a certain magnitude, if you have so many of those events, it changes the color of the map. This is how we prioritize our road maintenance. So our mine development folks can get out there and fix the roads and put the right priority on the right areas. So it's just another example of the technology we use with the data that comes off those trucks.
This is just a picture of some of the trucks that we have. It's actually a picture of the trucks that we had set out. That's not our whole fleet.
No.
All right, so to talk a little bit about some of the positions that we do have available. Right now, for specific to our Amransi site, we do have the diesel diagnostic mechanic positions, the diesel repair employee, and then the diesel maintenance helpers. So as Tony was discussing, there is opportunity for advancement within these positions. So the helper is going to be more of an entry-level position, promoting up to diesel repair and then also diesel diagnostic. So different levels to apply to and be able to promote. We also have boilermaker welders, diagnostic electricians, line electricians, and then some of our entry-level positions as well is going to be like our truck driver trainees and our laborers. There's also additional opportunities available within our different sites and at Morenci as well. And taking a look at some of those, that can be anything from engineers, HR, accounting, health and safety, warehouse, and environmental positions. You can look at fmjobs.com to see a full list of the jobs that we have available, as well as apply to any specific positions. So this graph right here just kind of shows our total compensation and benefits for each position, specific to our skilled trades like the diagnostic electricians, industrial electricians, the diagnostic mechanics, and repair employee positions. Right now, with certain positions, we are offering a $2,500 sign-on bonus potential specific to our Morenci, Safford, and Miami, Arizona locations. There's also a tool allowance, and Lee or Tony, do you want to talk a little bit about the tool allowance that's available for the mechanics?
Yeah, so within the company, they offer the $1,350 tool allowance. If you were to come and get a position out here, you would have to go and buy the tooling, and then, you know, you'd bring the receipt to your supervisor and they would put it on your next check. But it's a really great program. It helps to replace broken or lost tooling and keep your tools up to par.
Great. Thank you, Tony. So just to review some of the benefits that we offer with Freeport MechWarrior, so we do have different benefits. This is an in-depth look at all of them, but just to kind of go over a few specifics. So we do have three different medical plans to choose from, two different dental plans and vision as well. Benefits do start the first day of employment, and as well our retirement plans, we do a dollar for dollar match up to the first 5% of your contribution. And then we do an additional company contribution of 5% of your base pay. So the dollar for dollar match up to 5% is immediately vested, and the additional company contribution of 5% of base pay is vested after 36 months. All right, and that's all we have if anybody has any questions.
Okay, Pip, we do have a few questions. One of them is, how do I apply for apprenticeship program?
So our apprenticeship programs are gonna be on fmjobs.com. At this time, I don't believe that we have any apprenticeship positions posted, but if you do go to fmjobs.com, you can set up an account and set up email alerts so that way when any position becomes available, if it's a certain position or a certain location, you'll get email notifications.
Email alerts are absolutely perfect.
And I want to kind of touch on that for just a second, but we do have apprenticeships, but they usually come available as one class graduates and we get ready to start another class. So they're not available all the time or always posted, but they do come about usually once, sometimes twice a year.
Thank you.
Sounds good. Sounds good. Another question is, do you offer any assistance or advice for people to move to the area and work in Morenci?
So some of our positions do have relocation assistance available. It does depend on the position and the level of the position. So it just depends. That's something that we could discuss with candidates who apply as to whether a position is available for relocation assistance. Now, specific to our Morenci location, I had mentioned that Morenci does have company housing. Right now, there is a little bit of a wait list to get housing in Morenci just because of the sheer volume of employees that we have at the Morenci site. It's one of our largest mines. But we do have individuals that live in surrounding areas in the Morenci area. There's like Duncan, York, and Safford, and commute to work. And like I said, we also have individuals that live in Lordsburg and commute to Morenci as well.
Sounds good. Another question is, what is the starting pay for an apprenticeship?
So with the apprenticeship program, I don't have a specific dollar amount as to what that starts at. What we do as far as pay in general and just with all of our positions is it is based on an individual's, you know, experience and background and everything like that. So all of our positions and individuals who are selected for a position are reviewed by our compensation team to determine pay. So we always do give our best offer up front.
Great. What's the entry-level diesel mechanic work history background requirement?
So specific to the diesel, so we have the diesel maintenance helper, the diesel repair employee, and the diesel diagnostic mechanic. Christina, are you on? Do you want to talk a little bit about the requirements for those positions?
So for the diesel diagnostic electrician position, typically those positions require 4 years of experience in industrial, as an industrial electrician. And then we have the industrial electrician, which requires 2 years, and the diagnostic mechanic is typically 2 years of either diesel repair or working in an industrial environment. And then the diesel repair employee, typically that's 1 year of experience that's required for those positions.
And how about the helper? What are we looking for with helpers?
The helpers is just pretty much that you're somewhat mechanically inclined for those positions. And that's pretty much what we're looking for, helpers. And it's a great way to start up, start as a helper to work your way up into those other positions.
Okay, Liliana, do you see any other questions? All right. Well, we appreciate you guys. I've never seen equipment that big before. Just amazing. Really appreciate you coming in and telling us what's available, and best wishes, and certainly hope that some people out there will take advantage of what you have to offer.
Yes, thank you so much for having us.
Absolutely, have a really good one.
You too, thank you, bye.
At this time, I would like to introduce to you James Rodriguez with Panda Express.
Hey, how's everyone doing? Are you able to see me and hear me clearly?
Absolutely.
Awesome. So my name is James Rodriguez. I'm with Panda Express. I'm a general manager here in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Panda Express, fun fact, we go through about 4 million pounds of orange chicken. And I know for particularly at my location here in Albuquerque, I go through 1 ton of orange chicken. And yeah, amazing, amazing. Let's see. Cool. So a little bit about Panda Express, the origin. We started off in 1973 with Andrew Turing and his father right there is in the middle on the left. So that's Master Chef Ming Tsai. He opened the doors to the first Panda Inn in Pasadena, California. And the food was definitely inspired by Mandarin and Sichuan cuisine. After opening up a few Panda Inns, Andrew there on the far left, him and his wife on the far right, that's Peggy, they were actually wanted to do some type of a quick service, fast casual approach. So that's where they came with the idea of Panda Express. And so, you know, after 10 years of just, you know, success with the Panda Inn restaurants, they opened up the first one in Glendale, California. And it was a mall location. And, you know, Peggy, she helped, it just grew into this, you know, huge success of just, you know, really great, you know, American Chinese food. Let's see. Cool, so Panda today, okay? Panda today, we do about $3 billion in annual sales that across the nation. And we are internationally, we do have a footprint internationally. We're located in Russia. We're also located in Dubai. We're located in Mexico City, the Philippines. We're also located over in Guatemala. So we're really expanding our footprint internationally even more today. But, you know, we went from that first store back in 1973 to, you know, $3 billion in sales as a company. Our annual growth. So we have over 2,200 locations nationwide just here in the United States with over 42,000 associates nationwide. So, you know, we're able to, you know, interact with more guests and just serve more great Chinese food. So, Panda Express here in New Mexico was certified as a great place to work. We're also, the Fortune magazine also named us as a best workplace for women in 2020 and a best workplace for millennials in 2020 also. As you can see, this is a chart right here, graph of a great place to work right here. And a little bit about our culture. So, you know, our mission is to deliver an exceptional Asian dining experiences by building an organization where people are inspired to better their lives. So with that said, you know, we're the theme for our company is always investing in growth, always seeing the possibility in others and always, you know, cultivating from the beginning to, you know, creating an atmosphere and creating a person that, you know, is going to be better off just by working through Panda Express. And you can see that our values is, you know, proactive, respect, win-win, great operations, giving. And we also have our vision, which is to be recognized as a world leader in people development, to become loved by our guests, and our Panda Way, which is healthy lifestyle, continuous learning, developing others, and acknowledging others. And that right there is that's our founder and one of our co-founder and CEO. That's Andrew Turing today. And one day at Panda Express. So I'm gonna share some cool little fun facts about, you know, an average day of what a Panda Express, you know, and the hustle and bustle of operations of what a typical day may look like with, where'd it go? Well, that slide wasn't there. So in a typical day, we make about $7,000. You know, we have for drive-through operations, the job is demanding. You know, we're serving great food, but at the same time, we're doing it in a timely fashion. Let's see. For the career opportunities, growth, you know, we start right there at the entry level, which is a service and team and kitchen staff. From there, you can grow into becoming an assistant manager, to a general manager, to a training leader, all the way up to a vice president of operations. So the career, we do have a chef here in Albuquerque. He is a general manager now, and his name's Chef Raul. And he actually had an opportunity where he started as a kitchen staff, you know, just washing dishes, taking out trash, making fried rice chow mein. And he became a international operations chef. And I just love his story because as he grew with the company, he was able to open new stores internationally. So as I said before, when in Russia and in also Japan, we opened up restaurants, and in Dubai and in Guatemala and in Mexico City, the chef Raul, who's here in Albuquerque, he actually was able to go to all of those different locations and help train the staff there. So he was able to travel internationally while doing his job and loving what he does. And the awesome part about it is he was able to take his family with him also while traveling all over the world. So it was just it was a great experience for him, for his family, and for the company to, you know, continue to increase their footprint. So what we're looking for today. So I have about, Panda Express has about 60 positions open in the greater Albuquerque area. We have locations in Los Lunas and in Santa Fe. And so we are looking for positions. Positions are open in those cities also. So for our counter help, we do start off at $11 an hour. For shift leaders, $12.50. And kitchen helps, $12 an hour, and so on, as you see right here. from Cook for $1,350. So we are looking for part-time and we are looking for full-time. Part-time can be anywhere from, you know, 6 hours. That's one shift. One shift tends to be about 6 hours, all the way up to 40 hours a week. So we have about, like I said, 50 positions available here in the greater Albuquerque area and, you know, over in Las Lunas. These wages, these hourly rates do represent the Albuquerque area. I know Santa Fe is a little bit different, but for this right here, this is what we're, we have positions all over that are, we're actively seeking. A little bit about the compensation and benefits. So, you know, for the service and kitchen team member, it's about $23,000 in cash with about, you know, $5,600 in benefits. Total, it's going to be about $28,000. All of this right here is pretty much, you know, you get PTO when you work with Pan Express, all the way from just being an entry-level person. You know, we do offer 401k as a service and kitchen team member. And we also have educational assistance. So one of our values is continuous learning. So if you're, you know, we always are seeking to elevate, you know, how we see the world or how we see ourselves through either, you know, different self-help courses or, you know, Tony Robbins, John Maxwell, any of those type of courses. We offer a learning fund of about $525 a year so that you can attend those. That is reimbursable. So when you go, you know, and then when you go to the event, to the course, then everything's just reimbursable up to $525 a year. We also do have a educational tuition assistance. So it is a scholarship. We do pay up to $2,500 in tuition. So what that looks like is if you're going to community college or you're going to, you know, a state college or a university, then, you know, Panda will offer to, you know, pay up to $2,500 of tuition just so that you continue that continuous learning. And, you know, and for our management positions, you know, you do get a company car. So it's a win-win situation. Also, in addition to that, did I mention you get, you know, it's a fun work environment. I myself have fun every single day when I'm at work, and especially with my staff. You know, I love to have fun, but when it comes down to the job, I'm always serious about it. But I Panda Express is looking for people who want to have fun and also get paid for just, you know, serving great orange chicken or broccoli beef or Beijing beef. And did I mention you get free Panda Express all the time when you're working? Every single shift, you get free Panda. Let's see. And so, yeah, a little bit of right here. We do offer that 401k. These are some of the benefits offered. We do have a dependent care expense account. You know, continuous learning. Like I said, we have the Panda Scholarship, that learning benefit fund. You know, we do offer free Rosetta Stone for anyone looking to learn a second language. And we also have a hard times benefit, which associate support program. So, you know, for instance, we did have an associate where, you know, someone, you know, passed away in their family and they, you know, and they needed to be with their family during this, you know, during this challenging time. And, you know, with this support program, you know, it's a bank of, you know, PTO hours where all the stores help pitch in. And Panda Express actually pitches in also, and they were able to help this associate during this challenging time. And, you know, so that they could, you know, be out of work a little bit longer so that, you know, they could, you know, do what they needed to do to take care of themselves and their family. So with Panda Express is a family owned business still. So with that is that we care a lot about our people, and we want to make sure that we take care of of us first and making sure that we take care of our people first, because without people, we would not be here today. So we always make sure that we invest in growth and we invest in our people so that we can make sure that we have a fully functional operational organization. Cool. And remember, any questions you may have, just feel free to put them in the chat box and whatnot. Next, I do have a video that I want to share with you, and feel free to watch this short video.
Restaurant work is very joyful. Treating people well and performing at a very high level.
When I started Panda, I knew nothing but just washing dishes. I just kept being determined, and I managed to learn from cooking food to serving people to doing register and opening and closing the store.
Really, what took me by surprise was just how invested they are in their people. I've never felt so taken care of, so supported, really just believed in.
Panda Express would be a good company to work for because they treat their associates like family.
The person interviewing me was so friendly and genuine, and I can tell from the start that it was going to be good.
My favorite part about my job is I get to help others to better their life. The more I teach, the more I learn.
As a company, we are here to provide the skill set and also mindset to help you be successful.
I'm very interested in becoming the strong leader that I know I can be, so I can inspire others to do the same.
I am who I am today because of Panda Express supporting me and helping me grow.
Panda's mission is to inspire people to better themselves, to better their lives, to seek a fulfilling future.
If you're looking for a job that's going to take you farther than you thought you would go, apply at Panda and see where it takes you.
It would be one of the best experiences anybody can have. So at Panda. Sky is the limit. Restaurant work.
So how to apply? Just go to pandacareers.com. Search any store, 1158, or you can email your resume, or if you have any questions or anything, you can always email me and I can always get a response back to you. So if you're interested, go to pandacareers.com, select store 1158, and I am recruiting for all of the stores here in the greater Albuquerque area, Las Lunas, here in New Mexico. And just go ahead and just email me if you want to, at james.rodriguez@pandarg.com. And I would love to hear, you know, if anyone's interested in the positions or any questions that they may have, or they may know someone that's looking for an entry-level position or management position.
Well, James, I have to tell you, we definitely put you in the right spot because I am starving right now. and the food looks absolutely great. Got some questions here for you. One of them is, do you hire 16-year-old individuals?
Yes. So minimum age requirement is 16 years of age. So yes, we do.
Okay, very good.
And just to let you know that, you know, we are, each location is very flexible with their hours and with high school schedules or college schedules. So we're very flexible in our hours.
I've got a couple other questions for you. Uh-huh. Hold that thought just for a second. Just got want it. To let you know that in the chat box, there's James's email address at james.rodriguez@pandarg.com. And also, you can apply today at Panda Careers, and you can text, I believe, using the keyword 1158. Did I get that right?
Yeah, you got that right.
All right. Can you just briefly talk about real-world advancement opportunity?
Real-world advancement opportunities. So when it comes to, you know, growth in Panda Express, I would say for right now, we've had about 4 promotions in 3 stores. So they came in as counter helps, which is our entry level. And it took them about 1.5 years to advance to assistant managers. And we actually have 2 people who actually were hired about 2.5 years ago. They're going to be promoted to general managers here in the Albuquerque area. So when it comes to growth and advancement opportunities, it's definitely there. And it's happening right now. And this is such a great start for anyone's career, or if they're in management, you know, and to actually get into management in Panda Express. And nationally, 50% or more of general managers are making over $100,000.
Sounds good. A quick question about benefits. Do you get benefits only if you're full-time?
So, great question. All right. So benefits actually come when you work 30 hours or more. The benefits apply to associates who are working 30 hours or more. And you can be entry level. So you can be a counter help or a cook. It does not have to apply to, upper level management, such as like an assistant manager or a shift supervisor, 30 hours or more, and then you can qualify for the benefits.
So just correct me if I'm wrong on this. Since I'm hungry right now, if I was part time, does Panda still feed me?
Panda still feeds you. When you work on a shift, you get a free meal every single time. So that's one of the perks. You get a free meal.
Quick last question. In your 401k plan, is there any kind of matching that the company does?
Yes. So 401k plan, so Panda Express does match up to 4%. They match up to 4%.
Outstanding. James, we really appreciate you coming in. I'm going to be changing shifts here. So I'm going to hustle down to my closest Panda and get some orange chicken, but really appreciate you coming in and sharing all the information to these people. Have a great day.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
At this time, I would like to introduce somebody that's going to take over for me, and she will do an exceptional job. Her name is Tammy Gallegos-Burke. She is one of our business people. And Tammy, it is all yours.
Hello, my name is Tammy Gallegos-Burke, and I will be moderating the second portion of the event. Welcome to all who have just joined us. And for those who continue to join us, let's move on. Up next, we have Ace Hospitality. And I would like to welcome Armando Canellis and Ted Bolstad. Gentlemen, you have the floor.
Well, hello, everybody. Thank you for joining the job fair today. We really appreciate the opportunity to meet with you and virtually. One day we look to hopefully have these things in person, right? So just wanted to say thank you again for joining us. You can go to the next slide. So who we are, you know, Ace Hospitality is a outsourcing company. We partner with our hotels nationwide. We're in 10 states. Pre-pandemic, we had about 1,000 employees working in 10 states at many resorts and hospitality locations across the country. But we're actually focused here in Albuquerque. We're recruiting now for hospitality jobs here in Albuquerque. So just wanted to make sure that we got the word out. And if you know of anybody, if you're interested directly, or if you know of anybody that might be interested in working in the hospitality industry. We're making a comeback. You guys have been locked up and not traveling, and everybody knows that we want to get back out there and go swim in a resort pool or go see our relatives. So the hospitality industry is certainly coming back. So ACE is a partner in the hotel industry. We're hired to manage or work in different areas in the culinary. I'll cover that in a little bit, but we partner with our hotels. We're out here in Bernalillo with a resort out here, and we're looking to fill many positions. Next slide, please. So here's where we are. This is describes some of the areas in the hotel that we work with. You can see it's a variety of departments, you know, housekeeping, stewarding, in the convention services area. We even have some culinary jobs, laundry, things like that. So we run the gamut. But if you have your PhD, you're probably a little overqualified for what we're looking for. So we've talked about Panda Express, and I agree with Stuart, I'm kind of hungry. And then we talked, you know, before that it was mining, and those are fun trucks to drive. It looks like, reminds me of the Tonka trucks when I was a kid. So we're running the gamut of all the different opportunities today in this job there. Next slide, please. So here's some of the areas that we cover. We're in Washington State, Nevada, here in New Mexico. Florida is a big part, Minnesota, Wisconsin, and then that little green up area up in the Northeast is New Jersey and Connecticut. So we've got lots of opportunities, but we are focused here in Albuquerque, so that's why I'm here today. Next slide, please. So these are the specific jobs that I have open right now. It is housekeeping, stewarding, you know, basically dishwashers, and I have a supervisor position in the kitchen, managing the team in the stewarding area. So in those areas, that leader will handle ensuring that everything's clean and ready for banquets. The group meetings are picking up. There's a lot of orchestration between where things go, how we set up and prepare for big meetings, big functions, big dinner functions. It's actually a interesting and important job in the kitchen area. You work directly with the head chef and some of the other culinary experts in the kitchen. Next slide, please. So we do have some nice perks. We do have the health benefits. We have medical, dental, vision, work full-time hours, bi-weekly pay. We've got a great team. We really work on our blended family approach. So even though we don't work directly for the hotel, we are part of the team and the family. And so there's no difference. The guest does not know that I don't work directly for the hotel. There's no difference, and the pay is the same. Benefits are very close to the same. And as far as career growth, there's definitely some career growth. I can give you a story, just like our friend from Panda Express talked about Chef Raul. I can talk about Carlos Perez in our Florida location. He started with us about 8 years ago at the Hyatt Regency Sarasota. He was just a houseman. Then he became a supervisor of the houseman. Then he worked overnight and managed the cleaning of the kitchens. And then he moved to a daytime leader, then daytime manager, then an area manager. And then finally he moved to our Florida regional manager based out of Orlando. So he handles over 300 employees every day. So there is growth opportunity with us. You know, you show potential interest in growing with us. We'll be glad to work with you. And it's a great story, just like Chef Raul. You know, Carlos Perez is a great story of ours, and we love to promote from within. Next slide, please. So where here in Albuquerque will you work? Well, it's the Hyatt Regency Tamaya. We are a national contractor with Hyatt. So most of our locations are Hyatts, whether it be in Huntington Beach, California, Seattle, Washington, San Francisco area, Lake Tahoe, Minneapolis, New Jersey, Florida. We're all up and down the coast. If you like the beaches, you know, one day you join us here, we can always transfer you to someplace warm, right? We've had some crummy weather the last couple of days. Next slide, please. So thank you for having us. You know, my name is Ted and I'm the managing director. I'm based out of our Reno office and I'm here recruiting locally. Armando will be in town and talking to people starting Saturday. And then Jacinto is our local operating manager and he will be managing the team here in town full time. So you're welcome to reach out to us through our website. That phone number listed is Armando's direct line. And then of course, if you wanna send us a letter, no one uses letters anymore, but our address is there. And that's where the home office is and that's where payroll is done and all the benefits are administered through our administrative team there. So thank you again for the time today, the opportunity to tell you a little bit about ACE. Good luck in your job search, whatever you find. And we're excited for you to get back out of the workforce. The economy's coming back. The hotel industry is coming back and stronger. I hope you bought stock in Hyatt or Marriott because it's all coming back and there's plenty of jobs out there. So I'll be glad to take any questions if you have any. Thank you again for your time today.
Thank you, Ted. With all your great jobs, hopefully you will allow us all now to take those vacations again and stay in all those amazing hotels. If we don't have any questions out there, I actually have one. Do you have part-time employment there at the Tamaya?
Yes, we do.
Okay.
It would be focused on weekends because that's our busiest time. So we can do Friday, Saturday, Sunday, or Saturday, Sunday if you're interested in part-time. And if you're also interested in some different areas, I can also, if you send me your name, I can connect you with the hotel if there's something else, if you're more of a front desk agent or you like the valet parking. I can also, we're partners with the hotel, so we do have people that start with us and then end up working from the hotel down the road.
Awesome. Ted, our next question is, where is the hotel located?
It's in Bernalillo, it's on the Santa Ana Pueblo in Bernalillo. It's a beautiful hidden resort. I can let the cat out of the bag, but you're going to see this resort on ABC television here pretty soon. There were rumors around town, I think, but The Bachelorette was filmed here. So the new season will be right here on the resort.
Oh, that's exciting. And we have another question, Mr. Ted, and it says here, what is the starting compensation for most of the positions offered?
Depending on the position, it's between $12 and $16.30 an hour.
And would you, Ted, be willing to repeat the positions that you currently have available?
It's housekeeping, stewarding, and we have a supervisor in the stewarding area, more of a kitchen related position.
Okay. And are meals provided to your staff or provide any kind of discount of that nature?
Yes, there are. Meals are free in the employee cafeteria. Uniforms are free. Some locations in like LA and New York City, there's not free parking. Free parking's here. So there's plenty. You can get a snack for breakfast and have lunch and take a muffin home on your way out the door.
We also have a question here, and I'm thinking they're talking about the shifts. They're stating, what are the working hour groupings?
Oh yeah, so The dishwashing area is varied. It can be 7 to 3:30. It can also be 3 p.m. to 11 p.m. And I also have some overnight shifts, more kitchen detailing, that's 10 p.m. to 5 a.m. And then housekeeping is a daytime position.
Okay, wonderful. Another question that we have here is there opportunities for advancement?
Yes, definitely. We love to promote from within. That's kind of a hospitality industry standard. If you start out, show your determination and your willingness to advance, we'll identify you and work with you, get you some advanced training, offer some sort of extra education. And just as I mentioned with the Carlos Perez story, he started with us as a regular houseman and then currently a regional manager in charge of all of Florida. So that's one success story we like to share with as many people as possible.
Okay, wonderful. And just to reiterate, we would like you all to apply at www.acehsg.com or call Armando at 775-391-9425. And if we don't have any other questions, I sure would like to thank you so much, Ted, for joining us today and for presenting.
Thank you, Ms. Tammy. Thanks everybody for being online and good luck with your job hunt.
Thank you, Ted. Have a great day.
Bye, guys.
Bye-bye.
Treading water, trying to make my way to you. My senses are enchanted when I'm lost in something new. And I hear your October skies are colored like an evening fire. And that sounds like something I could use. It feels so true. When I'm with you, I'm free. A place I go that feels like home to me. And it feels so true. It's time well spent when I spend it with you. As I wander through the canyon, seems your beauty paints the way. The map I found in all my dreams, the marks from summer rain. Open my eyes to your night skies, the stars look like the fireflies. The sunset and let them come out and play. And it feels so true, when I'm with you I'm free. A place I go that feels like home to me. It feels so true. It's time well spent when I spend it with you. I've grown to fit into. As your seasons change, feelings stay. It's never been so true. And I love when your mountain lies underneath that warm sunrise. It's beauty I don't mind waking up to. And it feels so true. When I'm with you, I'm free. New Mexico. Thank you. spend when I spend it with you. It's time well spent when I spend it with you.
That was wonderful. That slide just there reminded me how much I enjoy working and living in New Mexico. So up next on the 12:30 hour, we have Ms. Kathy Lucero with the New Mexico Department of Health.
Good afternoon, everybody. Let me just get my screen shared. Okay, so my name is Kathy Lucero. I do work for the Department of Health. I work for one of the facilities within the Department of Health called the Los Lunas Community Program. The Los Lunas Community Program provides direct care and support to individuals who are developmentally disabled. These programs are located throughout Valencia County, with in the future hopes of expanding to Bernalillo County. So individuals from all parts of New Mexico are eligible for services for our program, which provides supported living, supported employment, and then our community membership of volunteerism opportunities. So we have three different programs. Our supported employment is called Valley Employment Services. What that is we provide people who are developmentally disabled to apply to be part of the VES program. And what happens is we help them find employment throughout Albuquerque and then Valencia County, which is more Belen, Los Lunas area. And so we pick these people up, we get them to their job, and we provide them the tools and the training that they need to be successful. Some of these jobs are actually within our program, LLCP, but then some are out. We have people that work at Walmart, for example, and then our staff would support them in their job. So they actually go with them and they're there helping them be successful. The other program is our actual in-home care. So we have currently 24 homes within Los Lunas Community Program in which we have generally two to four people in those homes. We provide 24/7 care. And it's a home environment just like you and I live in. And we just provide the support for the individuals that live in the home to do the same things that you and I would do every day. Go to a doctor appointment, go to work, go to the movies, whatever those activities might be, okay? The third one is just what we call our dayhab services. So they elect to be part of our program and we pick them up during the day. And so one of our individuals might live with their family, for example. We pick them up and we take them to do, again, like you and I would do throughout the day. So this might be taking them to the doctor, taking them to the movies, whatever the case may be. Those are our three services that we provide here at LLCP. So again, Los Lunas Community Programs LLCP is a facility within the New Mexico Department of Health. The Department of Health is the largest state agency within state government. I truly do enjoy working with DOH. I have been with DOH since 1999. So people kind of move around once they get into the state. I've enjoyed DOH so much. I have been with them for, 20 plus years. LLCP is kind of the safety net for the DD services. If you guys have heard of the DD waiver, that's what I'm kind of referring to. And we take pride in the service we provide to our individuals served. On your screen, you'll just kind of see the structure, the organizational structure. Today, I'm really focusing on our direct care positions. So as you see, I'm going to look over at the program director area, which directly reports to our executive director. And in this program director area, this is kind of our biggest this piece of our entire program. So we have our program director who sits over that entire department. And then he has three currently middle level managers, which we would call. And then we have a house supervisor for every single house that we employ. So right now we have 24 homes. We have a supervisor for each of those homes. And then we have our direct care staff underneath those supervisors. They're either labeled as site techs or home health aides. And these are the positions that provide this day-to-day care to our individuals we serve. So within the program for LLCP, we have a ton of variety of professional employees. We have nurses, registered nurses. We have LPNs, licensed practical nurses. We have certification medication aides, CMAs. We have our psychiatric technicians, our home health aides. We have in service coordinators, residential coordinators. And then we have, you know, more of our administrative side of it, which is the maintenance, secretarial, secretary, HR, and finance positions. So we have 243 positions that are in the direct care side, that program side that I just showed you on the organizational side. These positions are what we're always recruiting for. Psychiatric technicians and home health aides. That's our biggest piece. That's what we're always hiring. We also are currently looking for a registered nurse. On the screen, you'll see the education or experience that's required for these positions. For an RN, which is an RN advanced position, it's a pay band 75. We are looking for 3 years experience. And I just saw a typo on there. That's the wrong pay band. It's actually 2023 starts it, and the top is $35.21 an hour. These jobs are Monday through Friday. RRNs kind of are like case managers. They ensure that the health and care that our individuals receiving are top notch, and they are on top of appointments that they might need, any medications they might need, and then of course they do assessments if there's any issues. Our site tech, which we is our next one. The qualifications for this are 3 months direct experience and a high school diploma. Direct care experience means correction officers, caring for a family member in your home that may be sick or ill. That actually would relate to direct care experience, and it does not have to be paid. We have a variety of shifts available for our site techs. Generally, it's evening and graveyard shifts, but recently, unfortunately, due to the demand and need of staffing, we do have day shifts available. Our shifts run from 8 to 4 day, 4 to midnight evening, and midnight to 8 a.m. graveyard. We do pay shift differential from 6 p.m. to 7 a.m., and that's 70 cents per hour on top of your base pay. The home health aide basic, the qualifications are just a high school diploma. You don't need any experience. We'll give you that training that you need. This is a pay band 30, and somehow I have a typo here. That pay band actually starts at 1050, and the top of that pay band is 1552. Again, this has a variety of the shifts, and this also pays the shift differential. Some perks and benefits working for LLCP, right? So it is a state position within the Department of Health. We do on-the-job paid training. We are making a difference and enhancing the lives of people around us. And then we do have the benefits, right? We have medical, dental, vision, and life insurance. We have a differential for Spanish speakers. You get paid annual leave. You get to be part of the public employee retirement. Again, we have the shift differential, and we also do a sick leave incentive program. So if you don't use sick leave for a period of time, you end up getting a day worth of sick leave, 8 hours. Okay, so just some staff testimonials that I have here. I won't read them all, but... you know, we have a staff that just say it's getting to see the individuals and the difference that they're making of the lives of another person is truly making their job. ensuring and taking part of the health and safety and happiness of our individuals we serve, that's beneficial enough to our employees. We have a good tenure of staff here at LLCP. As you can see, one of the testimonies, we have a staff that's been here for 26 years, 4 months. I did a longevity research, and out of all of the current staff we had working, on average, the tenure for an employee with LLCP is 10 years. That's pretty good. I mean, that's pretty amazing. Like I said, I myself have worked for Department of Health for going on 22 years. So it's something we take pride in. Department of Health values their employees. And this is something we love. We love to get people in and help them advance and make a career here with us. Let's talk a little bit about that on-the-job training. So training for our staff is generally 2 to 3 weeks. And you actually come to training every day. And I have two trainers that run our new employee orientation. That's Monica and Nancy. Both of them together have 30 plus years of experience with LLCP. Both of my trainers have worked the floor. They've been direct care staff and they've promoted themselves up through the chain, and they actually became two of our trainers. So they have the hands-on knowledge and experience to provide amazing training to the people we employ. Our training covers a large variety of skills, and it focuses on taking care of a person who is developmentally disabled. So we truly believe our greatest assets are our employees, right? Our employees work hard to ensure that our individuals receive great service in everything that we do. We value our employees and the contributions and that they make and hold our mission and really play that mission out. We believe in teamwork, collaboration, and we try to make it as fun as a work environment that we can to set ourselves apart from other people. And we strive to make every employee feel valued. This is something that we feel strongly about in management, and we continue to try to better our program every single day and hear the feedback from our staff and move forward in making it just a better place and make people want to come to work. So that's kind of Los Lunas Community Programs in a nutshell. I am open to questions at this point.
Okay, I do have here a question, Ms. Kathy. Is there an opportunity for any overtime?
So good question, yes. Actually, right now, we do have a lot of overtime. Currently, with the COVID pandemic, we're seeing one of our strongest vacancy rates that we've ever had. We have a total of 287 total positions. About 243 of those are direct care staff, and I'm running about 60 vacancies. So there is overtime. Even when we're fully staffed, we have overtime. Overtime is paid at time and a half. And if it's one of those shifts that fall in between the 6 p.m. and 7 a.m., you get the additional 70 cents on top of your base pay. And then, of course, holidays are paid double time and a half. So, absolutely, there is opportunities for overtime.
Wonderful. The next question we have here, Ms. Kathy, is how do I apply?
So you apply through the state website. That is the spo.state.nm.us. And I will actually, let me just get to that slide. Right here's the slide, just so you guys can see that. You go on, you apply for our positions. You can do a search criteria once you're in the state personnel website. You can put in Department of Health. You can put in Los Lunas or Belen. Our jobs will show up in both locations. You will find positions. You can actually do a search by position too. You can do the home health aide or psychiatric technician, or the numbers on the screen. You can call my staff and they will actually bring you in and they will help you apply online and just help you through that process. And so there's a couple ways. You could do it on your own. You could call my staff. They could walk you through it over the phone, or you can actually call and come in and they'll help you apply for that job.
Wonderful. Another question we have, Ms. Kathy, is with the variety of jobs that you have, do you have any part-time shifts?
So we don't technically have part-time shifts at this point. We do have full-time shifts, but if somebody is truly interested, they could reach out to us and we can see if there's something we can do.
Okay, and next we have, what admin positions do you have and what do you require for those types of positions?
So admin positions right now open, we have a financial specialist position and we have a safety officer. Those positions are open. I don't have the qualifications directly in front of me. All of our positions at a minimum, because we are licensed by the Department of Developmental Disabilities, under DOH, we do require a high school diploma or GED. So each position is a little specific. Like I said, again, the actual admin positions we have are the safety officer and the finance specialist position. And if you want to get the specifics qualifications for those, you can contact my employee, Leora Schneider, at 321-8420.
Okay, and again, as Kathy stated, the place to go in and apply for these jobs would be at www.spo.state.nm.us. And I don't see any more questions for us here. Although, Ms. Kathy, we do know that these are state position jobs. Do any of these positions have any kind of sign-on bonuses or anything of that nature?
So, you know, it is a state job. Unfortunately, it's not kind of the private sector. There are no sign-on bonuses. But the good thing about the state position is your health insurance or any benefits you get start immediately within 30 days of employment. And then your retirement immediately kicks in. Your service time starts counting right away. I think what people don't realize is the retirement is a 30-year retirement. It is the state retirement. It is a good retirement. And then our health benefits, you know, what a person would pay out of pocket for their health benefits through the state is much cheaper than what they would pay through the private sector.
Okay, wonderful. Well, thank you, Ms. Kathy, for all the wonderful service that you're providing our community. And again, if you happen to have any further questions for Kathy, please feel free to call us at 505-843-1900. And we'll be more than happy to forward them on over to Kathy. Thank you, Kathy.
Thank you. Have a great day.
You too. Bye-bye. That was wonderful. Wonderful. That had me dancing here in my seat. Up next, we have Fidelity, as we just saw. And our presenters today are going to be Michael Hanyas, Cezan Copeland, Aaron Crowell, and Mr. Trevor Butland. Take it away.
Investments. Can everybody see the slide?
A little hard to hear you, Michael.
Can you hear me better now?
Yeah, that's better.
Okay. So we are Fidelity Investments. My name is Michael Annis. I'm a talent acquisition consultant, recruiter with Fidelity. And we're going to talk a little bit about kind of who we are, what we're recruiting for, and a little bit more about the region. So here you can see some pictures of the location here in Albuquerque to give you a little bit of overview. So Fidelity, we're a financial services firm. We offer a wide range of products, really ranging from personal investments to retirement benefits, wealth management, a whole slew of different benefit, different products. We have a pretty wide span, 12 regional centers spread out across nationwide, as well as over 200 investor centers throughout the United States. We also have a worldwide presence. We have offices in other countries, India, Ireland, China as well. Our regional centers, which is a little bit more about what we're gonna talk about today, are focused on helping our customers and really aligned with the personal investing and the workplace investing sides of the business. Albuquerque is one of our locations that's aligned to the workplace investing focus. Those are customers who have accounts through their employer. That could be anything from retirement, 401ks, to pension, to benefits, to health savings, a lot of different things. So you can see some pictures here of what the site looks like to give you an idea. So where are we located? This is, the address is 5401 Watson Drive Southeast. It is near the airport. You can see where the planes take off and land. We're pretty close there. Also close to the Isleta Amphitheater. So it's in the Mesa del Sol area, but those are some of the key landmarks there to give you an idea of where our regional center is located. To talk a little bit more detailed about the center, we have approximately 1,200 associates with the regional center. Some of the keys, takeaways here, we've been voted one of New Mexico's top places to work in the Albuquerque Journal. We have an on-site gym with machines and equipment provided, an on-site cafeteria with low-cost wellness options, as well as a grab-and-go option. So if you're on a hurry and in a break, you need something quick, got opportunities to be able to get something and be able to go on about your day. We are a tobacco-free campus, a business casual environment. We do have hybrid carpool parking, ADA and expectant mothers parking as well. So some key call outs there. Walking trails around the campus, Zen zones, which are great for de-stressing, kind of calming and taking a breather in between when you have those breaks, whether it be a break or lunch. All of our desks do raise and lower. So you can sit, stand, be able to move throughout the day and kind of keep that whatever's comfortable for you. We also offer dual monitors as well to make sure you've got the equipment that you need to be successful. The last thing there, volunteer opportunities are a big, big thing with Fidelity. Fidelity Cares is a huge initiative that we have. We try to make an impact in the community, not just in Albuquerque, but all over. But a big, big call out. We partner with a lot of places to try to do as many opportunities as we can to make that difference. So these are just some of the on-site amenities that we have to offer currently with the situation that we're in with COVID right now. We're being very cautious to make sure that the safety of our employees is top priority. So these are great. At some point, we'll be able to show everybody when everybody's back on site. We've all been working remote for a little bit over a year now. We're starting to have volunteers going back onto campus, back in the office when they're ready, starting that on a monthly basis and continuing to roll that out, just knowing that everyone is at a different place and will be comfortable at a different time. So a little bit about what we are hiring for. The role that we're hiring for, it's a financial services or financial customer associate is the title of the position. The pay for the role is $38,000 annually. It is an hourly role, so it breaks down to $18.26 per hour. We do offer full benefits, so medical, dental, vision, PTO. Those are just some of the key ones. We have a number of different benefits that Fidelity does offer in addition to that. And I will turn it over to Suzanne. She'll walk through and talk a little bit more about the position itself.
Great, thank you so much, Michael. Hi, everyone. My name is Suzanne Copeland. So I am the Talent Hiring and Retention Manager here on site along with Erin. So I wanted to touch on the key points of the role a little bit, as well as the background people be looking for. So the role, as Michael mentioned, is an inbound customer service role where our associates have the opportunity to assist our participants in achieving their retirement goals, which is extremely rewarding to be a part of on a daily basis. We also love that our associates now have the knowledge and can better prepare themselves for retirement. Our team educates our customers in regards to their specific employer benefits while also contributing to the larger team success, of course. Calls can range from less complicated calls like, you know, password resets, online navigation, to helping people take loans and withdrawals, even processing exchanges and moving money on the market on a regular basis. So it is nice you do get variety in your day, which is always great. Some of the backgrounds we're looking for. So we want to find those of you who really have a passion for customer service. If you're a natural educator, you know, you love helping customers understand more complex issues. And really, if you're looking for a company to grow and have a career with, we would love to speak with you. We're in a fast-paced environment with constant opportunities to learn and develop new and established skills. We absolutely welcome all learning styles and always look forward to fresh ideas, new insight that we can be constantly improving and retaining our lead in the market. That's something that we very much value here. A background in financial services is definitely not needed. We will train you and give you the tools to be ready to handle these calls. I myself came from retail in the service industry. I knew nothing about 401ks other than I was always told to get the match right. But I've been here for 5 years now. I still learn something new every day. It keeps me really engaged and motivated. I love being part of this team. On the next slide, I will cover our mission and our values as well. So of course, we are very customer driven. We always think of our customers' needs first, both internally and externally, which is really, really great to be a part of. We hope each interaction we have provides our participants with more knowledge than they started their call with. So they're walking away with that great experience every time. Collaboration and feedback are pillars of our success, both internally and externally. We like to have a team mentality to ensure that everyone feels they're set up to succeed, whether it's for their retirement or a long and healthy career on our team or both, right? I will now pass it off to my colleague, Erin, to cover what our onboarding program consists of and the way we'll support you through training as well as some of our resource groups.
Hi, everyone. I'm Erin Kroll. I'm Suzanne's plus one here in Albuquerque on the hiring team. And just kind of, I'll echo what Suzanne said. It is okay if you don't have any knowledge of 401ks or, you know, not really sure about financial services. We're really excited and happy to teach you. It can be a lot of information, so we do break it up for, you know, your day. So we'll teach you some stuff, then you'll get to go and practice it on the phones. And then we'll bring you back to the classroom and teach you some more stuff and then let you practice it again. We also have little different workshops to kind of go over in detail, maybe subjects that are a little more detailed and need a little more hands-on practice. So we definitely have those different types of workshops for you too, if something's not super clear. There is an accelerated learning path because it is self-directed. So a lot of that you can take on your own and kind of go at your own pace or maybe slow down a little bit if you need to as well. So definitely all learning types are welcome. Kind of just to touch on the support that you'll get. You're going to have an onboarding manager. You'll have an onboarding team lead. You'll have Suzanne and myself. And then also your peers. So you'll have a peer coach that comes in each day to kind of break things down for you and go into detail on the subjects that you learned for that day. And then also your peers, they're called peer guides that we put around you. That way, if you have in the moment questions, we have people there that can kind of walk you through the resources and, you know, what next steps you can take. So that's kind of what our training looks like. The next thing I'll go over is we do have our affinity groups, and diversity and inclusion is really big here at Fidelity. So we have a couple of, you know, focus area groups for our community, and these groups are open to all associates. So you don't have to fit in a certain box to be a part of these communities. But let me touch on a couple of them. We have our Asian Inclusivity and Multiculturalism group, and they're dedicated to enhancing awareness of the Asian culture through different events and community service opportunities. We have our Aspire group, and that group's focused on professional and personal experiences in the Latin and Black Fidelity Associates, open to all who are interested. We also have our Fidelity Veteran Employees, which is our 5 group, and that's, you know, a company-wide networking and support group for military veterans and kind of their day-to-day. We also have Fidelity Pride, and this is a group open to all employees, again, that, you know, kind of goes through the workplace experiences of our lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, and queer communities. We have our Women's Leadership group, and that's dedicated to help women at Fidelity grow personally, professionally, and financially. We also have our Enable group. And this is a resource group with a mission to create a positive and inclusive experience for all those affected by seen or unseen disabilities, permanent, temporary, or situational, just so we can make sure that everybody's reaching their full potential. So that's kind of a touch on the different community groups we have around here. And, you know, we really like to value a diverse group of people that come in here and really want to encourage that to grow and learn. And the next person we're going to have talking to you is Trevor. He's actually an associate for us, so he's going to kind of walk you through his journey that he's had here at Fidelity.
Hi, guys. My name is Trevor. I am a financial associate here at Fidelity Investments. They are correct. I never had like a background in from education through 401ks or pension. My leadership role is through more of a logistics side, but more importantly, I did have direct and indirect customer interactions every day. And this is what helped me succeed to where we are today. So if you have good education, learning, and you have great listening skills, it can give you experience to help you here at Fidelity Investments. And again, just to say what they said about the training online portion, it is exactly what it is. You have full support from day one. You're set up with all the tools needed. They surprise you with a laptop. They have a computer. You even get like a headset. And it helps you through your everyday journey here, because moving forward with Fidelity Investments, there's going to be challenges every day, all right? And you have peer guides, you have leadership, and you also have programs here. It's like an internal Google where you can research whatever you're looking for. And it's a very useful tool to help you get through some of those challenging calls. Another thing I want to tell you about is the peer guides, they're your best friends. They're one of your number one resources. So please don't feel scared when you do get looking at a new career. There's people that help you along the way here. And this helped me because I had no current role in business relationships as a financial associate. And here we are today, here I'm speaking to you guys about it. I do wanna speak to you about some of the products that we serve. Some of the products is the 401k accounts. So you're mainly handling withdrawals and sometimes loans from those accounts and setting up people's contributions. This is helping people develop and start their retirement program, and they can be seated when they're ready to retire. After 7 months, I took a dual leadership role as a pension specialist. So not only do I help people with their 401k, I help them with their pensions. Now it's two different products, but the goal is the same. To satisfy the customer, make sure they're successful in what they're doing, and assist them through the whole process. So I want to just let you guys know, it's been such a satisfying experience knowing that I'm helping people daily through their everyday lives, getting their pension, getting their 401k. So it's been a great experience. I do want to let you guys know, we have certain CSTs, what they're called is customer service teams. and I'm dedicated to a couple companies. And so that's why my knowledge, my experience is really broadened to help these particular customers or participants with their retirement. And it helps me engage with them more, understand their business more, and get them to the end goal, is the retirement. And one of the things I do want to touch base upon before I kick it back to the team is we have a lot of goals and opportunities here. With Fidelity, there's so many career paths you can take, and I'm on them now. I had celebrated my 1 year anniversary yesterday, and we have customer response teams. We have Quadro teams. We have operations specialist teams. You can even be a peer guide. So the opportunities are endless here. And I just want to say, my next goal here is to be a retirement benefit coordinator. And that would help somebody through their whole process of retirement. And I can't tell you the satisfaction of helping somebody. So if this role is for you and you are looking to satisfy yourself and other people and make them successful in life, this job is excellent for you. So that being said, I'd like to kick it back to the team if we have any questions and answers.
Awesome. It looks like we have a couple questions, so we could start with those. I could take the first one, Suzanne, if you want to take the next one, or if Michael, you want to take the next one, we can kind of go back and forth. It looks like the first one we have is, do you pay more for bilingual speakers? Yes, there are opportunities for that. This first step would be the entry level. So, you know, that would be something you'd have to master first, but there are bilingual opportunities after that for sure.
Perfect, thank you, Erin. So the next one, how many calls are you required to make per day? So this is an inbound customer service role. So you don't make any calls. I mean, you may have some follow-up calls that you need to make. But the call volume really can range on, you know, what product you're servicing, what client you're servicing, also the time of year, and events going on. So with COVID, we saw a huge spike in calls. With tax time, we'll see a spike in calls, and then there'll be days where, you know, you do get that time in between calls. So the volume really can range. We don't hold anybody accountable to the number of calls that they handle, though that's not a metric that we look at. I can cover the next one too. So for the company match for the 401k, we offer a very healthy match of 7% for our 401ks here. So a lot of great benefits here at Fidelity, between, you know, the compensation, bonus opportunities. Once you take on different products, we are really very passionate about helping people grow their careers here. So we don't expect anybody to kind of stay in this role. Normally you're going to take on another product relatively soon to training. So, and this is a full-time position. So this would not be a temporary position. We're hiring full-time right now with the company.
And Suzanne, you touched on the bonus opportunity just to add in. I don't think we touched when we touched on the pay, but we do have quarterly bonus opportunities. Those are based on your metrics, and you're eligible for up to 10% of your quarterly earnings. It is an hourly role, so anything over 40 hours is overtime. It is time and a half there, and those quarterly earnings, that overtime does factor into that as well.
Awesome. I have a question for you all. We do have a lot of individuals that currently are indeed looking for part-time positions. Do you have any of those available?
Not currently. Not to say that things aren't ever changing. So that opportunity might present itself, you know, down the road for the rest of the year, but currently we're hiring full-time only.
Okay, thank you. I don't see any other questions here for y'all. I do want to thank you guys for joining us here today on our presentation. You guys have a wonderful amount of jobs available to the community with great benefits. I am myself sold on the gym access. If you all have any questions in regards to Fidelity or other positions that they have available, please call us at 505-843-1900 and we'll be more than happy to forward them on over to Fidelity. Thank you, Michael, Erin, Trevor, and Suzanne. It's been a pleasure. And thank you for being part of this today.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us, Tammy.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Just a quick note, we are hiring monthly through the rest of the year. So, you know, if this month doesn't work out, just keep an eye out. We're hiring the whole year.
Wonderful. Perhaps we shall see you on the next.
Welcome back, everyone. It's that time again, Central New Mexico Hot Jobs. Get ready for some great opportunities in Sandoval, Bernalillo, Torrance, and Valencia County. Now here's Bianca with some information on how to get back to school.
Thank you, Sienna. Have you lost your job during the pandemic and are currently unemployed? A career change might be the right thing for you. New Mexico Workforce Connection might be able to offer you money to go back to school and get certifications to work in fields like transportation, healthcare, or information technology. If you're interested, please call 505-843-1907 or email wioa@wccnm.org. I have some great job opportunities for unemployed workers through our dislocated worker program. The first company our program is partnered with is J&D Foods, who is looking for several production workers at $13.30 an hour. Next is Tony and Guy, who is hiring for a marketing and admissions position at $17 an hour. Century Sign Builders is looking for both a finisher and an installer. The installer position pays $14 to $20 an hour, and the finisher position pays $13 to $15. Explora is looking for a camp manager at $14.50 to $17 an hour. Western Dermatology Consultants is looking for a medical receptionist at $13.50 an hour. Respec is looking for a help desk service specialist at $18 an hour. IVS is still looking for a service advisor assistant at $13.50 an hour. Sabio Systems is looking for an HR operations manager at $35 to $39K a year. Zamora Business Accounting is looking for administrative assistant at $12 to $16 an hour. Duke City Accounting and Consulting is looking for a staff accounting assistant at $13.30 an hour. And lastly, Ayanna Denise is looking for a holistic skin therapist at $20 an hour. If you're interested in any of these positions, please email an updated resume to bdelgado@wccnm.org. Let's pass it back to Sienna.
Thank you so much, Bianca. Veterans, give us a call today at 505-843-1900 to speak with one of our vet reps about the services that we can offer you. Now here's Liliana with some opportunities in Bernalillo County.
Hello, everybody. Thank you for joining us again. Today for Bernalillo County, we want to highlight these employers, Sandia Resort and Casino. They're opening soon and they need a responsible gaming coordinator to do so. They would like for the gaming coordinator to have 2 years experience related to responsible gaming. Lowe's Call Center is always looking to hire 100 call center representatives with 1 year experience. And they're an amazing top retailer with really good perks. Jabil is looking for an operator two with 1 year experience, one shipping associate with 1 year experience, and one production supervisor with 2 years of experience. Next, we have US Customs and Border Protection. Be a part of protecting our country while earning and providing for your family. They're looking for 100 Border Patrol agents with 1 year of experience. The pay starts at $49,000 per year. Loomis Cash Services is looking for a cash management service manager with 3 years experience in cash handling. Lynx Manufacturing Facilities is looking for one quality control new production specialist with 1 year of experience. Lynx is also looking for a purchasing agent starting at $16 per hour with 1 year of experience. Next, we have IES Communications. They are looking for a fire alarms life safety system project manager. The pay starts at $64,000 per year, and they would like for you to have 5 years of experience. Blue Cross Blue Shield of New Mexico is looking for a learning and development specialist with 2 years of experience. And Help New Mexico is looking for a compliance monitor with 2 years of experience. BOK Financial is one of the top banks in the US. They are looking for a credit specialist starting at $34,000 per year with 6 years of experience. Admiral Beverage Corporation and participating companies is looking for a delivery driver. And Rio Grande is looking for three administrative customer supports, must be able to type at least 20 words per minute. And they're looking for 10 distributing center associates, $13 to $15 an hour, must be able to lift 20 to 50 pounds, and also three jewelry manufacturing technicians with 5 years of jewelry making experience. And that's it for Bernalillo County. Next, we have Angela.
Thank you, Liliana, for those great opportunities out of Bernalillo County. Now let's take a look at Sandoval. First, we have the Santo Domingo Pueblo looking for one road maintenance personnel. Second, we have the Horizon AG product looking for one mine operator. Next, we have Calabra looking for one technical support specialist and one escalation representative. Continuing in Sandoval County, we have Insight looking for one janitor / custodian. Next, we have the Rio Rancho Public Schools looking for 20 custodians. And last, we have the five Sandoval Indian Pueblos looking for one cook and one health nutrition manager. That's it for Sandoval County. Now I'm going to pass this on to Elena to go over Valencia County.
Thank you, Angelo, for those opportunities. For Valencia County, we have Holcom, a corporation. It's the leading provider of transportation and maintenance services for public and private transit sectors. They have five openings for a road driver. We have Presbyterian with one opening for a medical assistant, Tri-State General Contractors. They have one opening for a construction superintendent. Next, we have Rax Building Supply. They have one position available for a CDL driver, must have a valid CDL and at least 1 year experience. Ace Hardware has five openings for a sales associate, and Valencia County has a position available for a laborer and a position available for a records clerk. And that is it for Valencia County. Now on to Earl for opportunities in Torrance County.
Thank you, Elena, for those great opportunities out of Valencia County. In Torrance County, we have Western Trail Veterinary Hospital, who are looking for one veterinary technician. Count Your Blessings Preschool are looking for four preschool teachers. Core Civic are looking for multiple positions, but today we're going to highlight their grievance coordinator. And Torrance County are looking for one data analyst, and they are also adding new positions almost every day. Continuing in Torrance County, Presbyterian Medical Services are looking for one development support assistant. Duke City Primary Care are looking for one medical assistant in allergy health. Waterway of New Mexico are looking for five field inspectors, with these positions being both part and full-time. Also, White Horse Ranch Santa Fe are looking for two life coaches and two mental health technicians. Finally, the Forest Stewards Youth Guild have opened up applications for their summer crew leader position. This is a temporary position spanning 10 weeks with the possibility of being kept on. The ideal candidate will supervise youth ranging from 16 to 19 years old. To apply for this position, please go to www.foreststewardsguild.org/FSYC or scan the QR code shown on your screen. That completes our county-by-county breakdown for our featured employers and their hot jobs for the week ending of May 14th, 2021. Make sure to tune in next week for some more incredible jobs. We do have some incredible upcoming events, but Jolene has the details on those.
Thank you for all those wonderful job opportunities. We have some upcoming events this coming week. First, we have Goodwill. They have a virtual recruitment event on May 18th at 11 a.m. They are hiring for multiple positions. If you are retail associates, career specialists, drivers, and many more. If you'd like to attend this event, please register in advance or join us on live on at Facebook at NM Workforce. The Department of Behavioral Health Services has an in-person job fair on May 19th at 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. at 590 Zuni Road, Southeast Albuquerque, New Mexico, 87108. Job opportunities in the field of behavioral health is a substance abuse technician, a substance abuse technician trainee, a clinical manager, case managers, and many more. They do have a hiring bonus available for full-time and regular positions. New Mexico Workforce Connection is hosting a large virtual career connection event on May 19th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. First, we have Century Sign Builders at 10 a.m., NORC at the University of Chicago at 10:30 a.m., Broad Spot Imaging at 11 a.m., Freeport McMoran at 11:30 a.m., Panda Express at 12 p.m., New Mexico Department of Health at 12:30 p.m., Fidelity at 1 p.m. and Blue Cross Blue Shield at 1:30 p.m. So please join us and see what all these employers have to offer you. Just a little quick recap on our upcoming events. We have Goodwill on May 18th at 11 a.m. The Department of Behavioral Services has an in-person job fair on May 19th from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. And New Mexico Workforce Connection is hosting a very large virtual career connection event on May 19th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. So if you're looking for a new exciting career, then please join us. To access our recruitment events, job fairs, upcoming event flyers, or hot jobs, please go to wccnm.org, select job fairs and hot jobs to access our event flyers to register in advance, or simply contact us. Now I'll pass it to Sienna.
Thank you so much, Jolene. Do you need a job referral? Give your local Workforce Connection a call with the job number or the employer you're interested in. They will review your resume and then go ahead and apply for that job at jobs.state.nm.us and then follow up with them. Thank you so much for joining us and thank you, team, for all of those wonderful opportunities. For more information or questions, please contact us at 505-843-1900 or send us an email at nmworkforceconnection@wccnm.org. Don't forget to follow us on social media at NM Workforce. Employers, contact us if you'd like to have your jobs featured on our weekly hot jobs. Job seekers, tune in next week for some more great opportunities. Have a wonderful weekend.
Wonderful. That was a great presentation of our weekly hot jobs. It's a great way to keep up to date with the recent jobs posted within your community. Up next, I would like to welcome Blue Cross Blue Shield of New Mexico, Ms. Jessica Aducci, recruiter. Take it away. Hi, Jessica. I don't mean to interrupt, but we're having some issues in hearing the audio.
Oh, my apologies. Can you hear me now?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much.
All right. Could you hear any of that first part? I'll just start over. Does that sound good?
Sounds great.
All right. I apologize, everybody, for the technical issue there with my audio. But again, thank you so much for joining us today. And we appreciate you hopping on at the 2:30 slot to hear a little bit about our company. We are Blue Cross Blue Shield of Illinois, New Mexico, Montana, Oklahoma, and Texas. But we are here today to talk to you a little bit about the opportunities in our Albuquerque, New Mexico office. So I myself am Jessica. As you see, I am a recruiter here at Blue Cross, and I have been handling our customer service division for just over 3 years now. And then alongside me, I also have Mariela Palacios. She is our senior talent acquisition consultant. And then alongside her, we have Katie Ritzky as well, who is our lead sourcer. So today we'd like to talk to you about a few different things. We'd like to just tell you briefly a little bit about ourselves as a company. And then I am going to cover our customer advocate position, which is a position that we're constantly filling in not only our Albuquerque office, but the offices in the 5 other states that we cover as well. And then we would like to dive a little bit into the job requirements and then company incentives that come along with that position. And then lastly, and most importantly, the application and interview process that you would go through if you apply to one of our roles here at Blue Cross. So to tell you a little bit about ourselves, we are Healthcare Service Corporation of Blue Cross and Blue Shield. Healthcare Service Corp is an independent licensee of Blue Cross and Blue Shield Association. We are one of the largest customer-owned health insurers in the United States, and we operate in Illinois, Montana, New Mexico, Oklahoma, and Texas. Our company was founded in 1936, and we serve more than 16 million members across 5 states, and we employ more than 24,000 people over the 60 local offices. So again, we do operate in those 5 states, and we have multiple offices in each state. So we do have a main purpose, mission, and value that we like to follow here as a company. Our purpose is always to do everything in our power to stand with our members, especially in sickness and health, given that we are insurance. Our mission is to always increase the access to quality, affordable healthcare across communities that we serve. It's very important to us. And then our values are always integrity, respect, commitment, excellence, and then caring, because we are in the healthcare industry. So to tell you a little bit about our customer advocate position, this is a role that we are constantly filling in all of our offices because we always are gaining new members and we always need additional help to provide for those members. So this position is going to be your general customer service call center role. In this role, you will be assisting providers and members with all issues and questions regarding to insurance. Most of the daily work will be done over telephone, and then you also will experience some written inquiries in this position as well. Some of the main duties, again, are really going to be advising on that plan information while you're on the phone, as well as potentially doing some research and inquiry status for that member or provider that calls in. Again, given that it is a customer service role, most of your work will be over the telephone, but again, you'll have some written inquiries, but you can expect some phone work. As for pay in this position, it does start out at $15 an hour, but along with that pay, we do include quarterly bonuses for those who are performing well in the role, and then you're always eligible for a yearly raise based on performance. So as long as you're doing well in the role, we want to reward you by increasing that pay. Some of the main benefits that come along with this role is we do provide a full benefits package. So we have multiple types of medical, dental, and vision plans that you can choose from when you're hired into this role. Alongside that, we also have a 401k and pension plan, which is huge because most companies do not offer a pension plan anymore. And if you plan to stay with Blue Cross for a long time, that pension plan is really going to come into play when it's your time to retire. One of the main benefits, it's one of my favorites, is a $300 wellness bonus. After a small checkup, which you can do at home, and then a small appointment that you'll have to complete with either a virtual nurse or going into a doctor's office, you're eligible for that $300. So that money can be used on anything such as a gym membership or even an Apple Watch, clothing, so new gym shoes, or even health supplements. So the list goes on and on about how you can use those dollars. And then lastly, another big one for many of our employees is the tuition reimbursement. So we have a lot of Blue Cross employees who currently attend school while they work for us as well. You know, we always want you to continue on your education with us. So that's a big perk as well. All right, so some of the requirements for this position, they're very general. Really all we're looking for is six months of customer service experience or even office experience, and then a high school diploma or GED. So when it comes to your customer service experience, it does not have to be specific to call center. We're just really looking for individuals who know how to interact with the public, you know, have maybe worked answering phone calls or working at a front desk, helping assist customers, even individuals who maybe have worked in retail or fast food. You can always be a good fit for this role. And then as for the education piece, again, a high school diploma or GED will need to be completed at the time of application in order to be eligible for this role. Some of the other preferred requirements you may see for this position when you apply is computer or communication skills. Again, this is not something that is going to knock you out of being eligible if you don't have it. But given that you are going to be on potentially multiple computer screens while working in this role, and then communicating a lot over the phone, these are two aspects that can come into play. If you have these skills, it's only going to help you. And then lastly, if you do have call center experience or an insurance background, it's just a plus because you'll understand the setting that you're going into. But again, it is not a requirement. And then lastly, some additional information that we do like to share about this role is these roles start in classes. So when you see a customer service position, formerly our customer advocate is the formal position name, we hire in classes. So when you see that position pop up, typically we're looking for 15, even to 25 individuals at a time. So it's definitely a great thing to apply because we're always hiring out a lot of people. We put these individuals through classes. So we have specific start dates where you'll go through a mandatory 12-week training prior to actually going off into the role on your own. We really want to make sure that you're comfortable in this position. You have a full understanding of it before we let you go off on your own. So we make sure that you understand our computer systems, all the different tools that you'll be utilizing, how to answer these phone calls, and then you'll even shadow current customer advocates so you can see some live settings that any situations that you may experience in the role. After training, you will pick out your hours with a manager. So training hours are typically 8 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. After training, our hours can range anytime between 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. So once training is over, you'll work with the manager to find a shift that works best for you, but just know that that shift can range between that 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. hour. And then this role also may include seasonal or weekend work where your schedules may change just based off business needs, but typically we may only see that happen about once a month. And then another thing that we do like to point out is this is an in-office role, as we feel it's most customer advocates perform best in an office setting. So it is not work from home, but you will have your first day of orientation from home. And then we do like to stress that there are a lot of roles at Blue Cross that do allow you to have that work from home ability. So after 1 year in the customer advocate role, you can explore other opportunities within the company that may have that option for you. All right, so why work for us? We really believe that not only our company, but especially this role are very meaningful and rewarding. This role especially is very critical to the company because without customer advocates, we cannot function as an insurance company. So we need these individuals. Another thing is you're really going to be helping the lives of others. A lot of times these people are calling in at stressful times in their life. So you're going to be the face behind HCFD who truly helps this individual get their questions answered regarding their insurance. Another big thing with us is opportunity for growth. So we really want to make sure that we are a company that allows you to grow and move into other opportunities, you know, so you can grow as an individual in your career. So we've seen many customer advocates start out in this role and then they quickly progress into a manager role and sometimes even supervisor. If that's not something of interest to you, you can always go into a different direction, as we have so many different avenues and opportunities that you can explore within the company that your experience may be a fit for. We also have really competitive benefits and pay. We really want to ensure that you're happy in your career and ensure that you're growing as an employee, as well as financially. So, you know, those pay increases are always a big part of your career. And then lastly, the benefits, especially if you plan on being a long-term employee, as discussed before, the 401k and pension are really going to be your best friend, you know, over time as you work for Blue Cross. Another big thing that we commit ourselves to here at Blue Cross is diversity and inclusion. Our opportunities are available to everyone, and we want to make sure that everybody knows that. You know, we work hard and we constantly do our best to make sure that we're reaching out to all individuals so they're included. And, you know, we're always focusing on groups such as Asian, Black, Latino, women, disabled, and military. So, you know, we do everything in our power to make sure that all these individuals are able to work for us. And then lastly, work-life balance. We understand that you need to have a life outside of work. So we offer generous PTO, including diversity days and personal days where you can take that time off for yourself, you know, so you have that. All right. So the most important part, which I'm sure everybody's curious about, is the application. Oh, my apologies. The application and interview process. So it's very easy to apply for all of the HCSC positions here with Blue Cross. You can easily search us on Google and just type in HCSC careers, and you'll find our career page. If you do apply to a job with us, typically and mainly for the customer advocate role, you will experience a video interview. So once you're deemed qualified for that role, you meet those minimum qualifications, you'll be sent an email to complete a virtual video interview that you can do at your own on your own time and convenience. Once you've submitted that to us, the managers will review that video interview, and then they put selected individuals through a phone interview who they feel are a good fit for the role. At that point in time, the managers will make their offers, and then they'll reach out to individuals who are selected for the role. And then anyone who is selected for any type of position here at Blue Cross and Blue Shield will be required to complete a background and drug test before starting in the role. So you'll need to complete that as well as clear that before we can actually start you in the position. All right, so we'd like to share this slide again, just so you know how you can connect and apply with us. Up at the top there, you can see the exact link that'll get you to our careers page. And then following that, we have all of our different social media sites that you can search us on and learn a little bit more about the company and the different departments. And then lastly, we've provided a QR code for you. So if you have your cell phone, feel free to scan it at this time. What this QR code is going to do for you is bring you to our talent community. So, you know, maybe we're not discussing an opportunity that you're interested in today, but you're curious of other opportunities available with HCSC. Scan this QR code and you'll be brought to a page where you can input a little bit of information about yourself, what your interests are career-wise, and then you can also upload your resume. From there, you'll be inputted into our talent community. And then anytime an opportunity comes available that is within one of the interests that you have career-wise, we will send you an email letting you know of that open opportunity so you can apply. I'll just sit on here for just another quick few seconds in case anybody else is taking the time to scan that QR code. All right, so that's all we have for Blue Cross. I know I've spoken quite a bit here, so we did want to take some time to answer any questions if there were any coming in. And then also I've provided my email here below. So if anybody applies to our customer advocate opportunity or anything else within Blue Cross, if you have any questions today that maybe come after the chat or you just don't want to ask in chat, feel free to reach out to me. I'm happy to do my best to answer any questions from anybody coming in. So let's take some questions here. We can look in the chat.
There are six questions. I don't know if we have time to answer all of them, but I do see six questions, Jessica. Seven.
Okay. All right. So it looks like the first one I see here is, when does the next training begin? So currently we just filled a class in Albuquerque, New Mexico. We do have another opening, but the next training date hasn't been determined. That position is open and online if you would like to apply. And then also you can keep my email on hand to reach out about any future opportunities. We're hoping to have the next opportunity come available, you know, by no later than August or September. Again, being that we just filled a class, typically the classes they usually start like every other month. So the best way to keep an eye out for those is to keep checking our career site as well and you know, join that talent community. Let's see, what is the dress code? When dress code in the office is business casual. We understand that you're sitting at a computer all day, so we want you to be comfortable. And of course you're on the phone. So, you know, really it's kind of case by case with office, but it's pretty much business casual. As for getting paid extra and speaking the Navajo language, we do have some opportunities that come about a few times a year where they will pay additionally for, you know, that additional language. A lot of times what we see more often than not is individuals will get into the role, and then after being in the role some time, when a certain office and location has a need for that, they will look for individuals who are already currently working for Blue Cross, and then give that pay incentive to those individuals, you know, who have that skill set. And then, yes, it looks like the work location was answered there. Thank you very much. It's the Albuquerque office is 25 Way, my apologies. Our office is, it looks like it's Balloon Fiesta Parkway is where it is. It's downtown Albuquerque there. And then, let's see, the shift time would be 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Albuquerque time zone, correct. Part-time shifts for this role, unfortunately, we don't see a lot of part-time shifts come in specifically for the customer advocate, but, you know, that's always something that we're willing to work with you on. So if you wanted to send me an email, we could always, you know, explore that a little bit more and see if there's any future opportunity. But usually, you know, usually they are looking for full time for the customer advocate role. Mariella, are you able to confirm on us for the downtown Albuquerque office there?
Sure.
To get the exact location. Mm-hmm. We're trying to find an exact address for you. We're currently located in Chicago here, so I want to make sure that we're providing the correct information for you. And feel free to, I know it says not an attendee here, but if you wanted to go ahead and email me at jessica_ducey@bcbsil.com, I can get you more information on the exact location of that office.
I'm going to go ahead and put it in the chat if that's okay with everyone.
Yeah, go ahead. Yes.
All right, so it actually, the headquarters is 5701 Balloon Fiesta Parkway, Northeast in Albuquerque.
Okay, so I apologize for the confusion there, but it is the Balloon Fiesta Parkway. Thank you, Mariella, for confirming that.
You're welcome.
All right, wonderful. So I don't see any other questions coming in at this time. So again, thank you so much, everybody, for joining us. And please check out our career site. We have plenty of opportunities outside of the customer advocate role. We are also always filling claims tech positions, which we do not have open at this time, but they're more of a written role rather than a phone role. So please check out our career site. And again, any questions or concerns, I'm always happy to assist. Even if you've submitted an application for something else, feel free to reach out to my email there. And, you know, we'd love to hear from you. So thank you so much, everybody, for joining in to hear about Blue Cross here at 2:30. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Jessica, Kate, and Mariela. It was a pleasure having you here today to join us. And just as Ms. Jessica said, if you guys have any questions, please feel free to reach out to her. If you all happen to miss any of this week's Career Connection virtual events, or perhaps you want to rewatch another one, please head on over to our Facebook page, which is at New Mexico Workforce, or go to www.wccnm.org to rewatch any of these events. Thank you so much all for joining, and we look forward to seeing you at the next. Have a great day.